Boom. Yeah, somebody talk to me, man. Somebody talk to me.
Yo.
Oh. What's up, brother? You want a piece of this darkness?
Darkness?
Darknesses?
Are you talking about the same darkness from,
I'm talking about your racist mother, son. I'm talking about your racist mother, son.
Like,
let me tell you something.
Fuck
you, light, you light skin motherfucker. Good lord. What's up, everybody? You want the classic throwdown intro? You want the classic throwdown intro? Fine, I'll give you a classic throwdown intro. A lot of people want the classic theme. Let's go to Throwdown 47. Maybe this is it. Oh, there's Mongoloid. Let's see if we can get the classic one. Let's see what this one. Wait, this ain't... What? That's not it. What's this? Wait, that's not it. Well, this is episode 40... What? That's the Debe song. Welcome. Man, this was April 2019. How's everybody doing tonight? Chilling out from my anger over the Boston Bruins Toronto loss. Wish there was hockey to talk about now. Oh. Oh, wait, there it is. There it is. There it is. Man, I got to go back to that look. That was really cool. Sitting in a movie theater with that playing on the screen. Look at that, man. The fuck is that?
What was that?
Was Tommy here? What the fuck?
I'm sorry, that was me.
Is that how you fart?
Man, is that all?
Oh my god!
Do all retards just leave their phone vibrating on top of their microphone? Is that what this is?
Who's in the mood for it?
There it is. There you go, here it is.
And I will throw down, knock your lights out. Throw
Well, there it was, man. Just a little sample of it. I got to get everything worked out with the audio company that I paid money for all these audio songs that now is copywriting me on the songs I bought. And literally in their agreement, it says, the part of the deal is you can use on YouTube or anywhere else. So, a little confused there. I don't know.
Well, you can use it. You just can't get paid anymore.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't matter on this channel, so it doesn't matter anyway over here, but... I don't want them to get paid because they're liars. I want my money back is what I want.
Right.
Is there any insurance when you pay this? Like,
I don't know.
Get hit with
insurance?
Something? Well, I'm saying if you get
hit
with...
You go to up to State Farm. Hey, can I get insurance in case someone fucks me out of $5?
Well, I mean, I got the contract and they're breaching the... They're lying. The contract says...
Yeah, I mean,
freedom to use at like on YouTube at will, like any, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, you don't need insurance for that. It's a contract.
Yeah, it says that I can
contract
use it.
Insurance.
It says I can use it on YouTube. I can use it on Facebook. I can make money with it on YouTube. I can whatever I want. I can sell up to a million copies of the song. I can do whatever I want to the song. I can alter the song. I am just the only thing it says that I can't do is sell the instrumental to a third party, like resell it almost. Like,
you so can't do what they do.
Right. I couldn't do what they do, but I could sell it. Like, if it's involved in art I've created, I can sell it. Or if I were to like sing over it or something, I could sell it. But I can't sell it as an instrumental. So that's it. That's the only thing it says. But then they claim it. So it's all stupid. Anyway, people are friggin' sick of hearing about it. So I don't need to say it again. But I mean, basically, you get it. YouTube's, I mean, not even YouTube. All the these companies are retarded. YouTube's retarded for not knowing what's going on. What's up, Quasi, man? We're live on Twitch, by the way. How's everybody on Twitch doing? Yummy. We're going to go exclusively on Twitch in a little while, so make sure you guys jump over there. You know, Throwdown started as an alternative show that I really wanted to do exclusively on Twitch, if you guys remember. The first episode of Throwdown took place from Twitch only, and that was the point. So I may start migrating that way if I feel like it soon, but maybe not. You never know, but just throwing it out there.
Are you making any more money on Twitch than YouTube?
I can play commercials on Twitch, but no, not really. I mean, like, I do because when I game, people drop a lot of bits and stuff. And yeah. people subscribe to it, you know. So, yeah, there's a little bit of stuff. There's a little bit of money being made on Twitch, but not a lot, you know. But, I mean, it's just a different place. I want to make sure I'm over there. And I got a better lawyer than JD's lawyer. JD's lawyer was like a fake lawyer, you know. That guy was a fake. I sent that shit to my lawyer. He was like, this is retarded. He's like, you might as well just stick this up your ass. He's like, but I've seen, what my lawyer said to me, though, dude, I'm going to kill somebody, dude. What the fuck, Casey? I'm muting you. I'm going to stab him. I'm going to stab him, bro. Yeah, what my lawyer said to me was, which is, you know, kind of what I thought anyway, you know, I said, the lawyer was like, but I've seen shit like this just escalate and just go crazy, and then you get all, then you have to take time out of your day to go to a court because of it, and you'll win, but it's so stupid. He's like, it's better to like reach out to this guy maybe and try to just stop, you know, try to pay him, no, leave him alone or whatever. And I'm like, yeah, well, the thing is, I do, and people do stuff to him, and they do stuff to me all the time, but I don't complain to him about it. You know, people to this day still do stuff. You know, they were in my chat the other day saying, like, you know, JD, fuck you, you're going to die. And it's like, I don't go running to JD, like, look what your listeners said to me. Because I know they're not listeners. I know it's trolls. Just like Tommy doesn't understand that either. Tommy goes, look what your audience does. It's like, dude, this isn't even, these are just fucking trolls, like most of them. And they're trolling you, whatever, just block them. And same thing with JD, but every time something happens to JD, he goes, well, that's what that community does. And, like, most likely the people that are shitting on him actually came from his community first, so it's really his community in mine, whatever. Who gives a crap? The bottom line is, these people are pussies.
It's okay if they're good people that come over. If they're able to take some of your people and make them your people and they're good, it's okay. But if they're bad people,
yeah. Nobody wants the bad. Nobody wants the bad people. By the way, like, and I've seen, like, the good people, they're flip-floppers, a lot of them. Like, they go, one minute they were JD's fans, the next minute they were mine. You know, I've seen people, like, on other people's shows, like, there was one guy in JB's chat, he's been blocked on mine forever, and the guy literally told, you know, JD that he was going to, like, stab his brother to death and kill him and stuff like that, and he was his fan, though, for a year. I remember the guy, he was always in his chat and my chat, then the guy's telling he's going to stab him, and then he came to my show, and I was like, dude, that was messed up, like, you're fucking crazy. And he was like, well, yeah, I was kidding, you know, and I had to apologize to him or whatever, and I asked JD, like, months later, and he was like, nah, I never said... I hate that guy. And I'm like, oh, really? And so then I was like, yeah, dude. I was like, that's messed up. And then the guy was like, oh, well, whatever. And he would still leave positive comments on my stuff and be like, yo, good show, Joe, whatever. And I'd be like, cool, but I'm ignoring this guy because he's weird. And then the next thing you know, he's going to kill me and stab me. And now he leaves my show. And now I see him on, you know, other people's stuff being like, you're great. Joe's a scumbag. You know, it's just like, this is what people do, dude. They're fucking losers. So many people do this, you know what I mean? And then I'm like, dude, that's the guy that wanted to stab JD. And, so eventually they'll turn on someone else too. And it's just like weird, dude. It's okay if you don't, it's like, why don't people just listen to what they want to listen to? Why do they always gotta, before they go, like, blow it up and create a weird attention thing for like a week where they're gonna come after your family or something? It's just weird. Like, everyone, there's a pattern to a lot of people that do this. Fucking schizophrenics are like insane on YouTube. You know, these people are running wild on YouTube. Like, once you don't get enough attention, you freak out or something. Like, I don't know what it is, man, but it's like a pattern with so many people. It's fucking crazy.
The thing I seem to be able to correlate with most of the people that do this is they feel like real life is YouTube.
Really?
Like, they live their entire day on YouTube.
But I was going to, well, I would think that they would be the opposite. I would think that it would be like people that don't think anything's real and they're just so bored, they're just jerking around. Like, and they don't mean anything. They're just being
right, but,
crazy.
But that in itself is such an addiction that they spend all day on YouTube doing that.
Right.
Or
well,
Twitter or what have you.
You might be right. Yeah. People on disability at home with nothing else to do usually is what it is. Or something like that. I don't know. It's weird.
I mean, I would think the average person that maybe has 30 minutes a day to pop on YouTube and check out what's going doesn't have time to mess with that.
Yeah, I don't.
They got better things to do.
Right. I think you're right. I think people get caught up in weirdness, but I don't know, man. But that's it's weird. It's some kind of psycho shit going on. So this big leak came out today about this isn't even a big deal to me. I don't really give a shit. I'll be honest. But I've heard about this for so long that I'm like,
no, it's
oh,
okay for you to not give a shit about one of your topics, but when I do it.
Yeah, but at least I can talk about it, you fucking miserable piece of boring. You'd rather go talk about, well, don't worry. We got a Karen for you today.
All right.
I got a Karen for you.
Get my hand on my dick.
You might have talked about it, but I don't know. But I got one. I don't know if she's a Karen, but all right. She's not really a Karen. She's just a psycho.
Is it the one you shared on Twitter earlier?
Yeah.
Not to give it away, but yeah, no,
yeah.
I haven't even
It's not
seen
a Karen,
yet.
But it's like, I don't know, she just sucks. I don't know.
It's in that same classification. I feel like anyone that gets shit on Twitter on a video is classified as a Karen now, and it's like, well, you know, there's a little bit of a separation there.
Yeah. Drew Barr goes, I'm on disability on YouTube all the time with nothing to do. I ain't sucked up in this shit. That's a good point, Drew Barr.
Well, I'm not saying everybody.
No, not everybody, but it's definitely people with time on their hands is what I'm saying. Like, it's got to be people that are like, have time on their hands. And there's some people with disabilities, they don't have time on their hands. They're like changing insulin and going to doctor's appointments, and they don't have time. But I mean, there's some people who just seem to be at home like, oh, you know, I got a bad back and I'm out of work. And then they sit there like with their like three computers open, like spying on people and doing weird shit. Like, I don't know, dude, it's weird. Strange stuff. But no, man, it's so this Luigi thing, let me get this out of the way. Cause like I said, I don't care, but this is a super popular topic for years. This is a big Nintendo leak. Luigi confirmed Super Mario 64. So people always thought Super Mario, Luigi was supposed to be in the game. Super Mario 64. People really wanted it. People really thought it was true. And, this leak, it's 1996. And I think when Super Mario 64 came out, and it's considered a classic. I'm reading the bullet points from Yahoo. One of the most prominent ones was proven to be true, despite not appearing in the game. Mario's brother and partner in heroism, Luigi, is apparently buried with the game's code, or he's in the game's code. So he's actually in there using the code, which was pulled from a massive Nintendo leak. Creative fans created an image of what he would look like. This is pretty cool. With over 25 years after launch, Nintendo 64 has become a magnet for conspiracy theories. There's a bunch of them. Isn't like something going on with like Mario's racist right now or something? Which is everything's racist now to psychos, but you know, whatever. Everything's racist now. Everyone's a racist psycho. And here's the look of what we're talking about over here. I don't know who this tweeted this Nitroid. I don't know who this is, but all of 2020 up to this point was just building up to the karma necessary to unlock Luigi in Super Mario 64.
God, I wish it was that simple.
Why does he look like an idiot? Is that really what they look like in Super Mario 64? I don't even remember.
I mean, that basically correlates to what Mario looked like, yeah.
Man, I mean, are we sure these guys are Italian and not... Look at that nose. Are we sure these guys are Italian?
Oh, he's hiding a dreidel under his hat, it looks like.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of, I don't know, bro. There's a lot of I mean, dude, that's a big nose, man.
That's where he's hiding his money.
Good Lord. Look at this nose. It's finally they leaked this out. I can't believe this isn't Italian anymore. I mean, are you sure this isn't Luigi Stiller or Luigi Steen? Like, I don't know. Okay. Anyway, that, no, that's a big schnoz, man. I don't know. That's Barbara Streisand, brother.
Mm.
But anyway.
He's cross-eyed, too.
Included a giga leak. Giga leak. Was a trove of Nintendo code from classic games. Yeah, so like somebody went through the code and found it. And wasn't it, I think there was a handheld where he was in it. So, you know what I mean? Like that, I don't know if that, what kind of code translates. I'm not nerdy enough to know how the code translates to the handhelds or anything like that. Mario is JD height, someone says. Jesus. Did you hear the English language is not racist? Yeah, well, I had a conversation with somebody the other day that was psychotic, I believe. Speaking of race and weird stuff in the world, I'm not going to tell you who this person was, but this conversation that I had was insane. I was in a conversation with somebody about the riots and the protesting and stuff like that, and I'm like, listen, I'm game for the protests. I'm game for protesting, but what I'm not game for is like people demanding, going into stores and being like, you must pay money to the black protesters because like you just need to do that. So if you had a store and they took over your block, they were coming in and they were like, oh, you need to pay a tax to us, like the people in Chaz over in Washington. And they were making white store owners give them money.
You need to give me money for running off my business.
Right.
It's the other way around.
But they were like, and anyway, that's a bully mentality, right? That's a bully thing. Going into a store being like, hey, that's a mob thing, actually. It's a mob thing. Hey, give us money or we'll fuck up your store. And trying to use like race or like reparations to hide behind it as if it's fucking Ted McAllister's job to pay the reparations when he's owning a store, struggling, trying to make a living. And now someone's coming in demanding he give money to them because he's white. That's racist. So that's racist, and it's a mob mentality, and it's a crime. And yeah, man, I was in this argument with somebody the other day, and what? Let me see where this started here. This is crazy. I said, a person going into a store demanding a store owner give them money is robbery. And then the person wrote black people. And then I said, it's actually racist to target white stores and take their money or we'll fuck up your store. I think that that's a racist thing. Then the person said, black people cannot be racist against white people.
What?
And then I said, you're a fucking idiot. Targeting someone for something because of their race is a racist maneuver. We can all be, anybody can be racist. Then they wrote, racism is based on one race using their statue as a higher person to keep minorities feeling small, not prejudice, but it is not racist. Hmm. And I said, okay.
Check Webster on that one.
And then I said, well, okay, it's a crime either way. And then they said, race is a social construct created by white male European settlers so they could be superior to everyone else and have an excuse to start a slave trade. Like, what? This person wrote this to me.
It sounds like they're trying to write their own dictionary.
Racism is a belief
that race is the primary determinant of human traits and capacities, and that racial differences produce. Gosh, geez, any more big words in a fucking definition?
Well, I followed up their comment with this. I said, a race is a group of human beings based on shared physical or social qualities in a category is generally viewed as distinct by society. And then I also proceeded to follow up with the word race and definitions of the word race in Japanese, Filipino, and in Chinese, and Latin, and also descriptions of the word and race going back over 400 years ago and before slavery. Therefore, the word race does exist to define the looks and qualities of a person. So saying that race is a social construct, what are we doing? Who? And let me tell you something. This is a person in college. What the fuck are the college teaching people? What is going on? I mean, absolutely, yes. Racist people have used race as a social construct to be superior to other people, and that's actually racism. But
I was
race.
Say, yep. Go ahead.
But no, but race is not that. The word race. So, like, basically, my statement that it's a crime, it's racist, you know, to target people that way. It's if there was an Asian person or even let's say a Hispanic person who was very white looking. Say a somewhat like Hispanic person, right, or someone from like Argentina or somebody like that, had a store, and people went in. And they were like, "Give us." Asians went in and were like, "Give us money. We're going into any stores that aren't Asians and demanding money." Most people would call that some kind of a racial attack or whatever, or at least, what's it called? Targeting, or there's another word I'm looking for, but whatever.
Profiling,
yeah, they profiled businesses to target for, well, what else but racism? or to get money, you know, it's a crime. And then it's like, well, no, it's not a crime because that race isn't a word. What the fuck are you talking about? Dude.
Like, whoever this person was you were talking to, they gave you an example of racism, but that's not the definition.
It wasn't Leah. It's somebody said, tell Leah to shut up the next time. Yeah, that's,
well, Leah's
no.
not in college right Leah's now, not, so that would...
It was not Leah, yeah. It's not Leah. It's not even somebody... It's not a family member. It's just somebody I talked to. But it's like... It's not Leah, though. No, it's not nobody you know. Nobody anybody would know, but... Oh, my God,
I found
dude.
A much simpler definition. I didn't want to throw 27 big words out there then everyone in the chat's going to be like, hey, you said what now? Racial prejudice or discrimination. It doesn't specify, you know, with the exception of white people, you're not going to find that in any dictionary, at least any dictionary with any rapport, you know.
Dude, that shit was crazy to me. Like, I mean, I don't know, bro. That was some crazy stuff, like, to me. But I don't know what's going on in the world right now, but that's being taught to people. That's crazy. That's some crazy shit, like, being taught to people. Yo, the Dryden Reich, what's up, dude? Dryden Reich, dude. Oh, I forgot the donations have been off. My bad. They're on now.
Shut up and bend over.
Here we go.
Finish it.
Oh, my God. Don't finish it. Please don't finish it.
I'm going to finish it. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey Joe, I am so hype you are doing Throwdown tonight.
Hell yeah.
You have honestly been a huge part of helping me get through the past few years.
Aww.
You and co-hosts always make me laugh. I turned 21 in a little over an hour and I need advice on what alcohol to buy.
Oh shit.
Dildo asses.
Oh my God, dude. Parker,
well,
man.
You know what
Drew's going to say? Gonna come.
Peanut butter whiskey.
Don't do that. Do not do peanut butter whiskey. Don't listen to Drew. That's crazy. You're an asshole for, like, even talking.
Well, you don't like peanut butter? Well, I mean, you can't
no,
have
I don't
peanut
know.
Butter whiskey.
No, so. I couldn't. Yeah, I wouldn't drink that. I got to be honest. I mean, dude,
I'm not a big peanut butter fan. I was surprised how much I enjoyed it when I tasted it. So, I don't know. You never know.
I would go. Yeah, I would go with, like... I mean, dude, I would go with maybe like Southern Comfort or like maybe a rum and coke. I'd go with rum and coke, Southern Comfort, tequila shots, margarita. That's my type of stuff. I'd go with margarita, man. That's what I would go with. Or just tequila. But can't go wrong with vodka and can't go wrong with Captain Morgan spiced rum.
I was trying to think of something special. You can have that kind of stuff any day of the week. It's just something you wouldn't normally have.
Well, if that's what you're saying, if it's his birthday,
I mean, you don't want just a rum and coke or a whiskey and coke. You want to get like a craft beer. You want to get some high end, maybe sipping whiskey or scotch. I don't know.
Jack Daniels.
I'd have to know what Parker likes, first of all, to even.
Parker likes.
Specific.
Well, you could go. You go with just Jack Daniels, man. Just get Jack Daniels. You know, you could pour Hypnotic in your ass, like take it like rectally. But I heard the ass cancer is crazy.
The bottle's shaped in a nice way. I think it wiggle up the ass pretty nicely.
Mm, yeah. I'm trying to think. Yeah, whiskey sour. This is a bunch. I would just, you know, I don't know. I don't know. That depends on his situation. If he's never drank before and he's deciding to drink tonight because it's his birthday or whatever, then happy birthday, by the way, Parker. But if he's drank, you know, a bunch since he was like 18 or something, and now it's his birthday and he doesn't know what to do, that's different. Then I would go super upscale. I'd go for what you just said, like the most, like bring me some crazy shit I've never had before. Like, let's do something whacked out, you know? You know what I mean? Like, back when I first started trying alcohol, it was like, here's some tequila and Goldschlager and Hypnotic and like stupid, what was the Aftershock, that stuff? You know, all the kids, they always had Aftershock, at least in my area. Goldschlager and Aftershock, like, huh, look, pink bottle and look, gold inside of a drink. You know, people were goofy. So maybe do that. Try that. I don't know, but if you know, you've drank a bunch of shit. If you've never drank before, though, then I would start with, you know, tequila and stuff like that.
What was your first alcoholic drink? Not beer.
Tequila.
It was just straight tequila?
Yep.
I'm not gonna answer mine then after that.
I pissed in a bucket. I pissed in a bucket. We have the video. I pissed in a bucket. I got so drunk that I was laughing and arguing and talking with my friends, and then I pissed in a bucket, dude. And we got it on video. I'm trying
to like that. Well,
I'm looking for it now because I got it. I show it to you. I was drunk and I pissed in a fucking bucket.
I mean, was this like a golden bucket? I mean, who hasn't pissed in a bucket?
Well, I mean, in my bedroom. In front of my friends after drinking tequila.
I'm thinking like you're out in the backyard. Oh, there's a bucket. Let's piss in it.
No, like I'm in my bedroom with my buddies and we're, you know, we got beers and my friend Bobby, his brother is older than us. So we were like 20, 19 and he was 21 and he was like, I'm going to get you guys fucked up. You know, so like that's what I'm talking about. Like we're in my room and he was like, yo, I'm trying to find what YouTube channel I have this on.
Parker says in the chat, by the way, I'm going for some crazy upscale shit.
Oh, you're going for some crazy upscale shit. All right. Okay. Oh, by the way, I found it. Oh, here we go. Oh, wait. Is this it? drunk and that's almost
I feel
it.
Like I've heard you tell. No, you had a different story that had to do with like pissing out in the woods or dude, shitting in the woods
I
or something.
I pissed in a bucket, bro. Pissed in a bucket, dude. Like, it's weird. Let me see. Oh, no. You're thinking of the shit in the woods thing.
Right. I corrected myself. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, man. I think I deleted it off this channel or I don't have it anymore. Mm-hmm. That's too bad because, dude, oh, my God. Why did I ever delete it? It was so funny. Like, it was great, dude. I had like, oh, my God, dude. I can't believe I deleted it. I think I deleted it. But I have a few other clips, but it's not the ones that. Oh my God, dude, the other one is, I mean, I have it still. It's just not on my YouTube, bro. It's on another YouTube channel, privated. I'm telling you, man, it was really funny. Like it was, I'm like pissing in the bucket and my buddy, they stole the tape from me out of the camera. The next day, later on, I tried to watch it back and my buddy, you know, is like, ah, dude, I'm not giving you the tape. I'm not telling you where it is, like all this stuff. And I'm like, dude, I'm not going to destroy the tape. Like, he thought I was going to destroy the tape or, like, throw it away or something like that. And I'm like, no, dude, like, I think it's funny. But he was convinced because it was so crazy. He's like, oh, you're going to take this and destroy the tape. And I'm like, no, I'm not going to. I liked it. I'll fucking watch this over and over again. But he was convinced that I was going to destroy the tape. And I'm like, absolutely not, dude. I'll keep this tape forever, dude.
Permanent on YouTube until they take it down for some bullshit reason.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm actually searching a couple more channels I have. Like, you know, like the old, I had them privated on the old Hate Man channel, I think, is where I thought it was. And I don't see it there. But I do miss Hate Man. It's too bad YouTube went to shit. The Ghostbusters Hate Man was great. I crapped on that movie.
Did you just totally shut that channel down or is it still there?
I think it's still there. But I think I shut down a lot of it because I was like, oh well, there you can't have any of this stuff.
It's probably in there somewhere. I just Obviously, you haven't uploaded there for a while, so
yeah.
I'll tell you one here. Let me grab it real quick.
Don't do that. Oh, I get what you're saying. Let me grab it real quick. Yeah, Drew's got something over there. I'm white trash, dude. So, you know, you're coming to the wrong guy from me.
I just I've still got old friends from the liquor industry, and I had a buddy bring this over to me the other day. It's and I love Jefferson Reserve, and he knows that. It's like 70, 80 bucks a bottle. This is Jefferson's Ocean Aged at the Sea Cask Strength. So they actually age it on boats at sea.
Wow.
And the humidity and the movement of the boat and the salt water and shit apparently gives it its own unique flavor.
Man, just like your mom gave everybody a unique flavor on all week long. Is she finally dead or is she gone?
No, she's I think she went to bed already.
How long is she staying with you?
Supposed to leave Thursday sometime.
Good Lord, man.
Well, not soon enough.
Speaking of drunk, now I don't have that video I was looking for, but I do have this video, and we are drunk.
I tickled it.
My buddy is laughing at me right now because my buddy literally has Bobby's brother, Jimmy, has this look on his face right here because I'm out of my mind right now. Like, I'm so drunk, dude. I'm going, I tickled it, dude. I tickled it. And I'm acting all just weird and gay and weird. Like, and I'm like, dude, I tickled it, dude. And he's just like, what the fuck is wrong with you? I don't know if you can hear this. The only left speaker's working for me.
What happened? I tickled it.
I win. Rob, deal with money.
Bob wins.
With money.
Because it's your board.
Yeah, no. Why do you like tying people up, mister? Do you know that is sexual?
I am loaded right here, dude. I'm loaded.
I'm so drunk.
So look, I still had the bald spot even then. Like, it's like that spot in my head, that's always been there. Look at that. Seriously, like this, like I'm not really that concerned anymore about what I look like because like that's always been there. I never noticed that, but I saw it the other day.
Do you wear
ball
caps a lot?
No, yeah, that's what it is. Look at that. That's 2003. But, like, you can't tell because normally my hair kind of falls the other way over it. But, I mean, that's crazy. I mean, it looks worse right here for some reason. But that's, I mean, like, that was 2003. And my hair stayed like this up until about 2011 or 12 when I had started, you know, with having kids. And then it starts actually coming out.
Why do you just leave it? Why don't you either try and grow it or just shave or something?
I don't like my hair gets all greasy, I feel like, and I don't like it. So I just shave it. That's why I shaved. My hair's shaved, basically. It's shaved.
Yeah, but I mean, you still have a bald spot with that much hair. I mean, it's still evident.
I shaved the shit out of my hair, dude. I just buzzed it.
But I mean, I guess if you wear a hat all the time, what does it matter?
It's thinned anyway. Yeah, my hair's thin. My hair's thinning, bro. But yeah. Look, that's hilarious. That's funny shit, dude.
It's
going to
be awesome. Where you guys going to stay? Just fine.
Dude, I'm fucking wrecked right here.
Why do I have to take a...
All right. Well, anyway, I didn't find the video I wanted, but, you know, someday we'll get that. What the hell was I doing? Oh, yeah, playing donations. My bad. What's up? Welcome to Throwdown. You've been here for an hour already, but I'm just babbling on. Where's my goddamn thing? There it is.
This smells like my vagina.
Happy birthday, Parker. James, thanks for the host, man, on Twitch. We're on Twitch for a little bit here. On Twitch for a little while. I got this video of this woman that we're going to show. We're on Corrupted Nation YouTube as well. Come on. Oh, no.
Why is my brother on the thumbnail and not me?
Whoa, that's a great point. Mario. It's me, Mario. Look at Onision just go. I mean, look at me go to town on Drew. Yeah, come here, Drew. Let me give you something, Drew. Mario, you know why. You know why, Mario. You know what you did. You're isn't Mario racist now? So you know what you did. You're racist, Mario. That's the problem.
Everything's going to be racist before long.
Everything's racist. Everything.
Blinking is racist.
Everything is racist! That's what people sound like to me. Where's that guy having a meltdown the other day?
Oh,
that I tweeted?
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Did you hear the reporter during the Trump press conference about doctors using alien DNA for a COVID cure? Some big is coming.
Yeah, bro. Something's going on, dude. Something is weird.
What are they called? Like demon sperm or something? I didn't get to catch it all. I just heard about it.
I'm sorry, but I can't help when I start hearing about this in thinking about Alex Jones on Joe Rogan a year ago when he said that they're cloning animals because they're going to mix animals with humans and they're going to be they want to insert this stuff into humans somehow, everybody. And I know that this sounds crazy, and I don't know if I believe this at all either. I don't know. But when I hear stuff like that, do you remember what I'm talking about with Alex Jones talking about, like, you know, because they were proving all the people that even Joe Rogan agreed. He goes, yeah, I know about that. That's true. And it's like, what? That they're using, like, they do this in China, like the cow DNA, and they mix with people to have this mix of a person and an animal, but it's not a person animal, and it's technically an alien in a way or something like that, and they talk about it. Like, there's all these things. And then the elite people and the deep state elite that are conversing with aliens, or they're in contact with aliens, and they're talking to them through, like, stuff like the DMT, and they're opening a portal. I mean, this sounds insane, but this is all stuff that Alex Jones was ranting about. And then, you know, Joe Rogan was confirming some of the stuff, even though Rogan was like, I don't know about all that and if I really believe that, but that's going on. So, and then when you say something like that to me, like, that really perks my fucking ears to the sky. Did you hear about the report during the Trump press conference about doctors using alien DNA for a COVID cure? I did not hear about that. That sounds crazy. Something weird is going on, man. I mean, I don't know what it is, but something's fucking weird. We all agree that something's weird. We don't know what it is, though. But something's weird.
The cure for COVID is to kill all the old people. Let's just get rid of them.
I mean, there's something going on.
We won't have to worry about it.
People are going missing all over the place like crazy more than ever. It's like, what's going on? It's weird. Let me see if I can find whatever Alex was ranting about when we saw this a year ago.
As long as we want, man.
No. Let's see here. Here we go. We're going to find it.
You were having.
Absolutely.
If you did know.
Absolutely. Listeners and the public are like, hey, Smollett's fake. The Covington kids are fake.
I'll do this and I'll eat my own asshole out in Mars. Wait till I find out about the dicks on Mars. Oh, yeah, there's dicks on Mars. You never heard about that? It's some kind of symbolic thing. Maybe they ran out of males. They ran out of males on Mars, and maybe it was some kind of signal like we need dick, we need testosterone, we need hormones, we need men. You know, we can fly down to Mars and impregnate the females on Mars. And so they draw gigantic genitalia, but it looks a little bit different. But the fact it looks like a penis.
Imagine that shit was real. We're gonna find it.
H is hate, and then just
so they just decide arbitrarily that you're a hateful person that you.
And bank accounts that I had for 20. Like, Alex, you're gonna influence things by being on the inside, anonymous, and all these AI weapon systems to direct your aircraft. So what I'm telling you is China has no rule. And we're going to take you along with us. So the idea that, well, if we don't give it to them, they're just going to rip it off. So let us go really give them all the big secrets and have Google last year tell the Pentagon, we're not going to help you with AI autonomous drones. But Google gave them all the latest AI. And I'll get into more sophisticated stuff in a moment. Gave them all the sophisticated AI, and now China announces they've got all these AI drones that are autonomous and all these AI weapon systems to direct their aircraft. So what I'm telling you is China has no rules. 20 years ago, they had cows that produced human milk. 20 years ago, they had spiders that produced body armor, spider guts. Okay, they have human-animal hybrids 30 years ago. They've got giant human tissue farms. You know, you hear, oh, your Achilles is torn. We've got a grown in a lab, a tendon. It's not a frickin' tendon grown in a lab. It's a frickin' deal, humanoid. These aren't humans. The way they get around it is
Wait a minute. We're saying so many things. Listen, I love you to death, but you say so many different things.
$10 million humanoids are real.
I believe they are. But you say so many different things without stopping. It's hard
because I'm reporting to the government agency, so they'll listen and investigate. I'm decompartmentalizing.
Okay,
but this will be studied for years.
So what?
That is my favorite part of the whole thing. This will be studied by. I'm decompartmentalizing. I'm getting it all out there, so this will be studied for years. He just says it really quickly, and it's true. It will be. This will be studied for years. He's not lying. I mean, that's what's funny is that's true. This will be studied for years by people that want to know where the information's coming from, how people are finding certain things out, and also from people that want to start investigating internally that aren't bad people to try to figure out who the bad people are. He's not wrong that it will be, but it's funny because he throws it out there so quickly. Like this will be studied for years.
You know, something I'm curious is, how is the government able to let's assume for a second that all these different conspiracies are true between aliens, the other dimensions, all the stuff that's always talked about.
Uh-huh.
Let's assume they're all true. How is it that no one has independently been able to capture some of this information and test it themselves and come out on their own and go, hey, look, I just created a wormhole. I've got an alien here.
Because mega smart people who have studied it can't even figure it out.
But the government, who's a bunch of fucking idiots and can't even work together, can?
No, they can't. That's the thing. According to Bob Lazar, they can't figure it out. According to Bob,
I'm not saying this stuff's not true. I'm just
no, I know. But I mean, according to the people that have been witnesses to being working on this stuff or seen this stuff, they're saying that we still don't know how anything works the right way or whatever. That's what they say. I don't know. And one of the reasons is because they're like, they think that the elements that the aliens or whatever use, they come from a place that not here. And so they're using something that we don't even have access to, like according to them. But there's this big nefarious other thing that the donation was about that. And that's what I'm talking about. You know, there's number one. You know, what's up with the aliens and the UFOs? There's definitely UFOs. And then it seems to be that there's some kind of off-world aliens or interdimensional aliens. And that sounded crazy. Like 20 years ago, being like interdimensional aliens, people would be like, what the fuck? But now, that's not so crazy. And we are all waves. We are all light and waves. We all are light and waves. Travels faster than the speed of light. Look at the mathematics. Look at the quantum mechanics of everything and everybody. It all equals energy and wavelengths and vibrations. We all everything is vibrating and in flux. That means things could be interdimensional or quasi-dimensional or quad-dimensional. Quantum mechanics right now is starting to uncover a lot of this stuff because we keep finding stuff out, and then we're like, this doesn't make any sense with what we knew. Oh, but you know, let's. But wait a minute, there's something in quantum mechanics theorizing this, and then it's true. And then the next thing you know, stuff in quantum mechanics keeps getting proven true. Theories that people had. When you start thinking about everything through waves of light and vibrations and mathematically, like everything comes out that way. It's not, we always think about things two-dimensionally and in physical form and physical terms, and it's not. And it's so much more. And that's what's going on, man. So, like, you could start with that and start with the aliens, start with the spacecraft, start with the anti-gravity units, because if you have anti-gravity, you can go all over the place. But the next step is the conspiracy after that is the, you know, the dark conspiracy of that there's something bad or nefarious going on here, and that the people in charge are deep state or scary people up above, you know, they're talking with these aliens, and there's something crazy going on or whacked out going on that we don't know about, you know. So that's a different step. That's another step. But that's what you're saying in your donation, and that's why I'm talking about this, because your donation referenced this, and the donation was from AJ Adams, and he said, again, I'm going to read it again. Did you hear Trump reporter during Trump press conference ask about doctors using alien DNA for a COVID cure? Something big is coming. I don't know about that. We're going to have to look that up. I don't know anything about that. So this whole thing that we started ranting about, I have no idea.
Start serving up alien dick. Let's start sucking on it. Let's get this thing over with. Hey, if it'll get this thing over with, I'll suck on an alien cock. Fuck it.
Yeah, if it comes down to it, Drew, you may have to suck the semen out of a fucking gurgloid. All right? And you may
I'll wait until I get it. I'm not using it as a vaccine, but if I get the fucking thing and they go, here, oh, it's alien cock.
We're going to find more, though. Yeah. We're not done with proven.
No, what I'm telling you is, Joe.
Yes.
Joe, it was in MIT Quarterly 25 years ago that they had human-animal embryos, but they killed them at the embryonic level. You can pull it up. They've got humanoids.
I believe this. They've already used CRISPR to enhance children.
With higher intelligence.
Yes.
In China.
Well, it was a side effect, they believe, of making them.
Boost their intelligence.
HIV. It was something about HIV, immune to HIV.
Joe.
Yes.
Everything 100%. They roll out has already been tested.
Oh, I believe you.
But it has an aim. So let me tell you what's really going on. The globalists want to play God. They have what they call a breakaway civilization. So instead of talking about the breakaway civilization, I was talking about
This is what I wanted to bring up was the breakaway civilization. Look this up later.
Sandy Hook, which I get, and I appreciate you letting me cover, and I'm sorry it ever happened. I believed it happened. I'm sorry for people's pain. And then I ask the families, and I ask the lawyers, and I ask them all, stop in my name, saying I'm the wolf at the door, saying go after these families, and stop running around to the news everywhere saying Alex Jones says Sandy Hook didn't happen. Because the media...
Well, I don't know why he's going into Sandy Hook.
But the media is the most unpopular thing in the world with 7% approval rating in Gallup. So when they say that I say it's fake, that sends people... about it. They're going to have a big event up there in Connecticut. You understand? And they're going to blame it on me. So I'm saying, no, no, no. I believe it happened. Stop saying I said it didn't happen. And stop saying that I'm saying no kids died. Because I want to talk about human-animal hybrids and humanoids. Because, Joe, why has it got to be a humanoid?
Why?
Because if you make it a few percentage points another animal or another creature... It's a gray area. There's no human rights. You have an animal rights movement. You have a human rights movement. There's no alien movement. Right. Aliens are real. They're creating human-animal hybrids that are a new creature, never here on Earth. It's alien. So the aliens are already here. AI is alien. The chimeras are alien. Aliens are already here.
So you're saying they're making these human-animal hybrids so they could, harvest tissue from them?
That's just level one.
What's level two? What's level eight?
Because I'll tell you, a lot, for the best of my knowledge.
What's level eight? That's the funniest.
A lot of people think, it's human harvesting of Falun Gong, who are these Buddhists really healthy. That's big. That's going on because they still have a better non-rejection rate. But with the chimeras, I remember 22 years ago reading a BBC article that was kind of testing the waters. They occasionally test it. And they go, about 15 years ago, the first animal-human chimeras were made in test tubes. They were not brought to term. But some scientists want to implant them in utero in cows because obviously that's a bigger uterus. You can grow up a bigger humanoid and get more tissue. And so then I went, I better go research that. So I went to UT Library at that time. You could get some on the internet in like 1996. And I went and actually pulled up all these MIT reports. And I took them to my dad and other people who's a doctor. And they go, yeah, that's really crazy. And it was all about how we've got to prepare the public for this because we're going to be able to download their memories and then put it in a new body. This is before Blade Runner. So see, it's not like this is the world's not imitating Blade Runner. Blade Runner is a preparation for what's coming. And they're telling you, more human than human, this is going to be more advanced. This is going to be better. But like everything, like a cell phone or like a vaccine, it's got a Trojan horse. It's got a back door. It's already been tested. It's already been perfected. It's being rolled out. You're not given the real technology. You're not given the real life extension. You're given the crap, Joe. And the Earth is seen as like an egg yolk to give the propulsion power for this new thing that's going to be born. And whether you believe that or not, just like when
the new thing meaning artificial intelligence?
Beyond that. It's a fusion of artificial intelligence and a whole synthesis of new life forms. And so that's...
He's out of breath right there, man. He's out of breath. There's more to it, though, that really that doesn't really relate exactly to what I was trying to talk about because of the donation, but it sort of sounds like that.
I'll tell you, Alex Jones sure as hell took the red pill. That's for damn sure.
Yeah, bro. I mean, listen, the guy, he's, you know, he finds things out, though. You know, he throws a lot of things at the wall. And
no, I like it.
When, you know, it's kind of like when, you know, a lot of us are very cautious, right? A lot of us are very meticulous and cautious. Like, I think because of a lot of reasonable whatever, that I'm going to go over there and I'm going to dig a hole over here because I think there's gold over here. And then you spend your whole life digging that one hole. Like, I got some good reliance that there's something under this hole. And most people dig the entire hole, and they never find anything. They dig one hole, and they never find anything. Once in a while, somebody finds something. But a lot of us don't find anything. Keep digging the hole as far down as you can dig it. Or maybe you hit rock eventually, and you go, oh, shit. So then maybe you start another hole, and you're like, oh, I'll start another hole. Alex Jones starts digging a million holes all at once and just fucking digging them. And just fucking, he's got ADD, like dig a hole here, dig a hole there, dig a hole here. And so at the end of the day, Alex Jones, you know, he has a lot of failed holes. Like he has more failed holes than anybody else. But he comes out going, look, I found a dinosaur bone. Look, I found gold. Look, I found a fucking a dead body. Meanwhile, everybody else comes up with nothing or maybe one thing. And or maybe and everybody else has one, two, or three holes. But Alex Jones has like 90 holes, and he comes up with stuff. Sometimes he comes up with nothing. But like that's like my analogy of him. He just fucking throws shit at the wall, and eventually like he finds some truths that nobody else would have found because he's so determined to investigate so many different things that the idea that a few of them are going to be right, it happens. It's like playing Diablo. The biggest thing, the comparison to me is Diablo. You're playing Diablo, and you go on a run for 5 minutes, and you kill 100 monsters, and you find maybe one thing, and you don't really find much, and then after a couple runs, you go, ah, oh God, I'm sick of this game. I'm not getting anything. But another person who's a dork sits down and plays for like 3 hours straight, and he doesn't fuck around and look at his loot and play around with his loot. He goes into the rift, kills a bunch of fucking shit, gets out, closes it, gets back in, kills a bunch of shit, gets out, closes it, gets back in. And those are the people that in the game you find have all these primals and crazy weapons because they're efficient, because they just keep going back and doing it and doing it and doing it and doing it, and they come up with stuff. Whereas a lot of other people are more meticulous and slow, and I'm only going to, you know, talk about stuff that I find out is true or that we want to build a narrative on. So everybody is really busy building a narrative or talking about one thing that's true and verified, whereas Jones is about digging down every rabbit hole and throwing it all out there. And that's why
Jesus, I was just going to say it reminds me of Ring Toss. You wouldn't like this 5-minute explanation about Diablo.
Yeah, I'm sorry, man. I lost my mind, man. It's Ring Toss. Yeah, it's Ring Toss. Exactly. You got a fucking huge bucket. Boom, 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 boom. You're just throwing it. Yeah, I don't know, dude. Like, that's what, I don't know, bro. It's what it is to me. I wish I could find the better example, though, for everybody, because it's really weird. You know, some people hate the guy, some people like the guy, but every time he says all this crazy stuff, then the next thing you know, something comes out. It's like Bob Lazar back in the day. You used to think, oh, this guy's probably lying or whatever, but I don't know. It's really interesting. And then it's like, wow, that was true from what he said. That's interesting in the late 90s. Then in the mid-2000s, another thing. Oh, that ended up being true. Wow. Shit, Bob was right about that too. What the fuck? And now recently, we see the crafts. And you go, oh, shit. That's doing exactly what Bob Lazar said. You know, I don't know. And so here's a new conspiracy, right? Which is what Alex was kind of talking about there. What if this is like the government or the elite or a secret organization or a group that knows about all this technology and has all this technology, and they're going to implant these super people as aliens and try to pull them off as aliens? Do you know what I'm saying? Like try to like put, like give them access to the crafts. And this technology that we have, for some reason, maybe was left over, and we're trying to create an event where aliens land or something to see. I don't know why, though. I don't know why that would be, that you would be fooling people that there's actually aliens when really we created these things and it's some sort of deception. I don't know what that means. I don't know why that is. Why would you do that? Like, oh, maybe to come out and say, like, these aliens are super powered, they could kill us at any point. We have to follow their rules that they have for us, or they will kill us all. Like, there's nothing we can do to fight back. We already know that. And here's the thing. They want us to do this. Like, I mean, I don't know. This is crazy shit. But, like, I'm just saying, I don't know. Or are there aliens? Or are there interdimensional aliens? And they're all around. And that's why every once in a while they pop out and come and go. And the reason is because they're interdimensional. And once in a while, to use the equipment, you know, they're fluxing in and out of the our visibility. Or, you know, they're operating on a wavelength we don't see. That could be too. That could be something too. There's so many things, man. We could go.
There's a million possibilities. Yeah, I'm down for whatever. I just don't know enough about it. All this shit's over my head. I'll be honest. I'm ignorant to a lot of it. I'm down for all the studies and the hypotheses and that, but it's...
Well, you can prove this stuff if you go...
Jesus, Casey looks like a fucking...
pedophile. Hey, Casey.
You're like frozen in time.
Casey, are you banned from the playground by any chance?
He's like, you muted me.
Joe, there's a video of Excalibur saying the N-word at a PWG event taunting his opponent. Yeah, I mean, I've seen that video for years. I mean, the question is that going to become a new thing? I mean, you know, why wasn't he suspended like Sammy Guevara, you know? But yeah, I don't know, man. I'm so done with what people did in the past. The guy did it at an event in public. So, you know that the guy was doing it to get heat and that they planned it in the heat or whatever. I don't know, dude. Like, I don't think Excalibur is racist, you know, but I don't know the guy at all. I don't think he is or isn't. I don't know. But that to me is an angle. We'll see if the mob gets him and he gets in trouble for it, you know, or whatever. I don't know. We'll find out. But, you know, I've said the word too, but a lot of people have said the word. It's like, but nobody's actually said it to a person in hate or anything like that. And I think the guy, yeah, I don't know what's going to happen with that, but I've seen that video for years, you know, but, we'll see what happens. Let me, grab the donos again, see what's going on.
My name is Ryback.
Oh,
Ryback. Give me some more money. My name's Ryback. I want that money, money, money. My name is fucking Ryback. Give me some more money. Money is my crack. My name's Ryback.
Ryback.
Finish it, yeah. Fat body burner.
Guess who's back, bitches?
Oh, he's been gone a couple weeks. Soundwave. 92. Soundwave. Back in the game and keeping Throwdown on the air, man. Thank you, Soundwave 92, for keeping Throwdown alive, son. Come on! Sith Negan, yes, I got to upload the Demo God, the Birthday Party Fire song. I thought I did the Birthday Party Fire song. I really didn't do that? And the new Ryback songs. Thank you for pestering me, though, dude. I appreciate it. But no, Sith, I don't, dude, can you remind me where those songs exist? Because that's been my problem. I've been looking for them, and I can't fucking find them. And I literally am stupid. Soundwave, man, thank you so much, brother. What a bombshell, man. $40 coming in. That'll pay for Throwdown tonight, brother. Thank you, dude. Joe sounds like Beavis. What? I don't get that one. Yeah, give me some more money. My name is Ryback. Look at Casey, man. He's about to abduct a child.
He might be one of those aliens.
Did he freeze like that? Oh, my God. You were just standing like that?
I think.
Oh, my God. Good Lord, man. Oh, you're a Jets fan. That explains all of this. You're muted. I'm keeping him muted. Just sit there and look. Sit there and look muted. Keep sitting there and look muted, Casey.
Yeah, he. This is perfect. He's a typical Jets fan, talking a bunch of shit, but no one can hear it.
Right. Right, with no results. Like, tons of the Patriots are out, dude. I want the football season to just end at this point. Like, I mean, I don't even care. Patrick Chung is out of the Patriots. Dante Hightower is out. Those are our two best defensemen are opting out of the season. Like,
because of COVID?
Because they're high risk for COVID or high risk or something if they get it.
You're a fucking athlete.
How you playing football? I mean, but, if that's the case, then nobody should be playing football. Dude, I mean, you think I'm going to watch football? I'm not going to watch. Tom Brady's gone, and our defense is gone because they're all opting out. I'm not fucking watching the football season. I'll keep watching hockey, but I ain't watching football. Fuck football this year. I ain't watching it. Patrick Chung?
I'm at a loss on that one. I mean, you're a fucking athlete. You get paid millions of dollars. Piss off and play the game or don't. Get the fuck out.
Well, they are getting the fuck out.
Someone else. Yeah, exactly. But don't fucking come back then.
Well, I think they'd be sued or something. I don't know. Somebody would be sued.
Is it in their contract that they could just sit out?
Yeah, I guess so.
Did they sign a contract that a pandemic can give them the right to just sit out of their contract?
Apparently. or there's special terms that they're, you know, coming to about starting the season.
I mean, maybe I don't know enough about the story, but maybe the teams offered the opt-out.
Maybe.
Maybe.
It's been agreed upon by the Players Association, so and the NFL and the team and everybody.
Yeah, well, then what are you going to do? I mean.
Oh, Hightower had a child this month. That might be why. Hightower had a kid.
I'm working my job still, so.
Everybody's working their jobs with kids. What the hell? What? I don't get it.
Well, I mean, with COVID, too.
Yeah, with COVID. I don't understand it.
The vast, vast, vast majority of people
in
this thing are over the age of 70. What is the average age?
Mr. Blackwolf is... We're getting info from Mr. Blackwolf. One has a newborn, which I don't think is an excuse because tons of people have newborns that have to go to work. So if a football star doesn't have to go to work, then why the fuck does everybody else have to go to work?
I get 3 days if I have a kid, or if my wife has a kid, that is.
They have a clause that lets them sit out for low money, but their contract rolls over. And also, one has a family at home with diabetes. But a lot of people have family at home with diabetes.
My mother has COPD.
Oh, boy.
And again, I'm rooting for it, but
this is bullshit. Beside the point. You know what? Fuck these people, man. There's people working at Walmart right now with fucking diabetes. You know, yeah. What the fuck? What are
you're
they talking
paid
about?
That kind of money, you need to go to your fucking job. Your fucking 3 hour a week job.
How about
I
no
get it. They practice and shit like that, but you know, I work off the clock too.
Jacob, I think Casey wants to make love to you.
Yo, what's good, guys?
What's up, man?
What's up, baby?
What up? Yo, please don't wear that Jets jersey on here. Please take that
Yeah,
shit
man,
off.
We really should shoot him.
Please burn that
Oh,
shit
it's a
off.
Green Bay.
Please burn it.
Is that Green Bay?
You guys have
no,
never
It says yeah. Jets, unless he's like trying to say.
Oh, it's Joe. Is that Joe Namath? Is that Namath?
No, it's when Favre was with the Jets.
Oh, I thought it was Favre. That's why I thought it was Green Bay.
That doesn't help any. He sucked with the Jets.
You bought a Favre jersey when he was on the Jets and you're wearing it?
He was on the Jets? What the fuck?
Dude, do you have a shotgun in your house? Blow your brains out. Like, I mean, what the hell, dude?
I think I'm enjoying Casey.
Do you have slaves in your basement?
Dude, I'm sorry. Casey, I really do like you, but I kind of hate you. You should be thrown down a flight of stairs. You were in a Brett Favre jersey from the Jets. Nobody should ever wear a Favre jersey. Never wear a Favre jersey that doesn't say Green Bay on it. Never,
and
ever.
Still don't wear it.
And even still then, yeah, don't wear it. Because I would have double bagged it. I would have double bagged it. Would you have double bagged it? I would have double bagged it. I would have double bagged it. When's that commercial from? 2003? 2004? I don't know.
That was a long time ago. Yeah, it's got to be almost 20 years.
Oh, what a double bug. They played that commercial like 900,000 times. We all know what it is. That's how much they played it.
Is he going to get props since he can't talk? Is that what he's doing?
I hope that
is he throwing himself down a flight of stairs, maybe?
I hope somebody robs. Look at all these games, man. I mean, you're looking at like fucking $25,000 right there.
Boy, that would suck if he got doxxed. You know people are going to that house.
Yeah. I mean, if you
Most
ever.
Yeah, they're going to let all the kids free. They're going to let all the kids free.
Yeah. If you look at like Guerrilla Warfare, Nintendo, and you open up the game and pull the sleeve open, that's where you find the pitchers. That's where you find the hidden pitchers and the little map that tells you where the little case is buried underneath his house with the Wi-Fi signal. Unbelievable. What a sick person wears a Jets Favre jersey. I want to throw up all over Drew. I'm going to throw up
We've
on somebody.
We've got a new Twitch follower. Hell yeah. Take my pants off.
Yo, Attitude Era Kid, thanks for the follow on Twitch, man. What's up, Twitch, man? If you want to go commercial free, come on over to YouTube right now.
Well, listen, I can't even talk shit because the Giants suck. And they're going to continue sucking.
Oh, yeah. Well... The Dried Reich, man, thanks for subbing to the channel on Twitch, man. Thank you for the sub on Twitch. Much appreciated. Yeah, we're going to keep Casey muted. Going to keep him. Now he's a Panthers fan.
What?
Now he's a Panthers fan. I mean, we know that this jersey is. It's got to be a white guy.
I have to be a white guy.
Turn around. Let me see that name.
Engel.
Turn a little more. I can't see it.
Is that Luke? Yeah.
Yeah, see? Told you. Told you. This guy would never buy a black man's jersey.
Oh, sick. A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Fuck you, Cronin. You don't want me on your show. Well, I could care less, you Foxborough bitch. You and this whole stupid community can kiss my froggy ass. I hope Danny Mount finds you and rapes your ass. I got my own show with Dr. Earl, so fuck everyone and JB.
The retards.
Bullfrog, just don't forget to ask your mommy to tuck you into bed tonight, okay?
Man, I
fucking idiot.
Heart attack can't come fast enough, brother. You dummy.
Tell me about it.
Why don't you go have on your thing again?
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly?
I'm banning everybody
stuff.
That's in your chat, you idiot.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Let's get froggy. Who wants to get froggy? Follow me at Mighty Bullfrog 1 so I can sexually harass you and mums the younger the better too, and I love black dick. I don't care for black live though. Only thing coons are good for is having a fat dick and I want it.
Come on.
Come on, man. Coons. What the hell? Jesus.
Leave the coons alone.
God damn it. Dude, I had a raccoon the other day outside run into the bushes away from me, and I was like trying to wait it out to watch it come out of the bushes, and finally it did, dude, and it looked at me, it went like this and then stopped, and its hand was up like in the like that, and it stopped and looked at me and like froze, and then I like started moving, and then when I got back in the house it resumed like running away. It was really funny, dude. It was like it like the froze like I couldn't see it.
Raccoons are fucking
like if
raccoons
I,
are fucking weirdos,
dude. It thought if it froze I couldn't see it. It was like I was like, what are you doing? Sith Negan. Sith Negan. 16 months in a row subscribed over a year as a $25 producer.
Months. Damn.
Damn. Arushin Chew's like 34 months.
Yeah, I think he just broke 30.
Yeah,
is
he
insane.
Did. Yo, Sith Negan,
30
man.
Fucking months.
Thank you, brother. Yeah, 34.
Oh,
3 years.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly? Look at this.
16 months, baby.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Casey, you didn't deny that you were telling 8 years olds that your dick juice tastes like gummy bears. Does that mean you love your cousins in the incest way?
So, we really do have something in common.
That made me want to throw up just now. I almost threw up just now.
Jacob, with that Make America Great Again hat. Definitely a Trump supporter.
I know you would say that too. I know you would fucking say that too.
Yeah, man, I like it. It's okay. You can wear
it. It's tricky business wearing a red hat with white lettering on it nowadays.
Isn't it, dude? Especially if you're a white guy.
Yeah. Smoke weed every day.
Pat Mick of. Oh, God.
I can't wait to get Ryback on my show so can get shell shocked in my ass while my two yes men cheer me on. Watch Ryback take it to the hole.
Oh, God. I would love if they got. I wish they'd get in a real fight. Yeah. Yeah. I wish they would.
Ryback fight. Can he fight?
You know, maybe, but he's a. I just know that he's a baby. He's a psycho. He probably can fight.
Just because you're an athlete, doesn't mean you can fight. Trust me on that one.
But I bet he could beat someone's ass. I think he could. I mean, he's so big. He's just so big.
I bet you could beat his ass.
I think I could kick him in the head. But the thing is, dude, like I think he can absorb a lot of pain though. That's the real problem. But I would kick him in the head, dude. I would never attempt to body shot him or anything. There would be balls and head. That's it with him. If I was to fight Ryback, I could kick him and knock him out. That's the only way. I could never punch him, knock him out. I bet you I could punch him all day. He wouldn't be knocked out. But I know I could kick him and knock him out. So that would be my strategy. Not to give it away, but
start
I would.
Call your buddy Phil to give you a strategy for that one.
Yeah, punks at Tony Phil. He's another guy that can take a lot of punishment. Hey, guys, we're ending the stream on Twitch. Come on over to YouTube, Corrupted Nation. Thanks for being on Twitch, man. We'll be back later next time.
I've got to point this out. Casey has worn three different jerseys for a total combined of one Super Bowl win. And that one win was the fucking fluke. Well, you're just used to failure, aren't you?
Oh, 14 months from Broken Lion, man. Thank you, Broken Lion, on Twitch, right as I end the Twitch stream. But I'm ending the Twitch stream because...
It is life.
Yo, Broken Lion, thanks, man. Because I want to play some... Is this it? Is this the guy screaming? Where's the guy screaming? Oh, God. I'm looking for the guy screaming who's like... I tweeted this the other day. A lot of people saw this. Remember the guy screaming? He's like, they're fucking doing this to us!
I must have missed that one.
Oh, my God. It's wicked funny. Oh, God. It's so funny. I got to find it, man. It's so funny. I tweeted it. I swear to God, I tweeted this out. Or maybe I just liked it. I swear to God, I tweeted it, though. He's like, they're doing this to us! It's like wicked funny.
I can't believe I turned 26 today.
I can't believe... I'm 36. Yeah,
I just came home from dinner with the family. I'm fucking old, bro.
With the family.
Shit, 26. 20 fucking 6, bro.
You fucking... I should slap you.
A lot of birthdays here this last week.
You want to be 36? Trade places with you if you want.
Shit. I want to stay 26 forever.
I'd say that's a pretty perfect year. 23, 26. I'd even take 28, but right after around 28 and beyond, things change a little bit. And you're like, oh, I would say probably 28 and beyond. Where is that fucking video of that guy, man? Oh, my God. I swear to God, I tweeted it. I liked it. What the fuck? I can't find it. Fucking hilarious.
Wish I could help you out on this one. What are you wearing now? If that's a Blues jersey, you're going to get hung up on. You know that, right?
Oh. That's a Chargers jersey, and they don't know where their team's supposed to be. The Chargers are all fucked up.
What, do you just get the jerseys that are on discount because they don't win?
Yeah, my cock is made of chocolate.
I like how I sat here and waited for a response like I was going to get one.
Yeah, pretty sure it's a no. I think there might be... No, I don't think there's any. Leah's looking for chocolate. She's like, any chocolate down there? I'm like, yeah, my dick is made of chocolate. It's funny you say that.
You know, white Oreos are racist, too. Speaking of racist stuff.
You know, we had a lot of people sign up on Patreon the other day because of your mother. I really believe it's because of your mother. And Dave Rose saying he's going to rape her and all that stuff.
I was going to say, you had Dave and Troy on there, too. I mean, there was a lot going on that night.
I'd do it.
Yeah, I mean,
I've seen your mom. I've seen your mom speak before on camera.
I would smash her.
I mean, yeah.
Have you seen the standoff with these two guys? Level. What is this, the Wild West?
Holy shit.
Whoa.
Casey, that's as bad as someone who wears a Joe Montana Chiefs jersey or a Cardinals Emmitt Smith.
Yeah, that's pretty...
And at least Montana got them to the championship game.
Right.
I mean... Favre and the Jets. That's like fucking suicide.
That's just stupid. I mean, maybe like have it for the collectors. The
during COVID.
Maybe have it for the collectors, you know, because it might be worth something, maybe. But I mean, like, to wear that, like, you just, like, that's just fucked up, dude. That's like putting on a used condom that you found on the ground.
I'm telling you, these are like garage sales or clearance racks.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. Hey, that's
want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
The Red Sox are poop.
Eazy-E 86. Yep. Thanks for the $3. Well, you know what?
Agree.
Why don't you go fucking... I hope Yankee Stadium melts into a pile of piss.
I was going to say this.
Motherfucker.
27. That's all I got to say.
That's going to be your age next year.
Yeah, Eazy-E wants to go die again.
Oh no, my God, yeah. Oh my God. Eazy-E.
Get AIDS again, right? Yeah.
That's funny. Drew said something funny. Holy shit, bro. That's pretty good. Gotta give it to you. This is the Wild West, bro.
Are we allowed to call this a Mexican standoff anymore, or is that racist, too?
He looks like he might be Armenian, and the white guy looks like he might be, like, some kind of German, or... I don't know.
Listen, the guy in the red shirt has the guy pointing at the guy's head, so I think he'll win this battle.
That's a great point.
It looks like it's aimed at his left arm.
And this guy is shooting at his fucking, what, stomach?
Well, he does.
Johnny Faye.
The guy on the left looks like he's got the heart tagged. And quite honestly, the guy on the left has a better shot because He's got both hands on his gun, and he's rested on that door. So if he that shoots that gun, he's going to have a clean shot at that guy's heart. However, if the guy in the right shoots, that gun is going to have some recoil, and he's loosely holding the gun. And that guy's wearing a helmet that might actually maybe protect him. So honestly, the better shot here is, I don't know. I'm going with the guy in the black shirt because he's got two hands on the gun. The guy in the red probably already positioned his gun that way and now is stuck. Because if he makes a move with his left hand, he's afraid he's going to get shot. And the guy on the black is already trained. So if I was viewing this, I myself would actually lower my weapon probably, unless this guy was, you know, like threatening to like hijack my car or something like that. I might actually pull my gun away and say, all right, I'm going to pull mine down first. Or I would describe that to him and say, listen, I'm going to withdraw my gun first. Are you going to withdraw your gun and we can stop this? Cause this is stupid, you know, cause I don't want to hurt you and you don't want to hurt me. So why are we doing this? And then maybe if he went, yeah, then go ahead. And then if I did, I'd do it, you know, because like you have a worse shot, or shoot the guy in the head. You know what I mean? I don't know. Say he was going to take your vehicle. I don't know. You're in your car. This guy doesn't have to be on this guy's car. So I don't know what to say.
Either way, it'll be less two crackers in the fucking.
You ridiculous piece of shit.
Oh my God. That's fucking hilarious.
One weird standoff right here. How do you back away from this?
I don't know, dude.
Who backs away first?
Someone says something the right way that de-escalates, or someone gets shot.
A third party will have to come in. I don't know. How did this end? Where's the fucking rest of the video?
Can you imagine what other countries think about us right now?
Yeah, dude. They think we're fucking crazy. Like
they're doing what we were doing years ago, sitting back and watching all the fire.
That's right.
Watching the party.
Well, you know, if we actually had a video of all the people that get stabbed in the UK, well, you would think they're crazy too, to be honest. I'm serious. If we started showing all the videos of all the stabbings in the UK, you'd be like, what the fuck is wrong with this country? But nobody does that, so. I don't know. Oh, yeah, here it is. Oh, my God.
I saw this. What is this? You promised
me us! What do you. Go figure, another white guy. Another
white guy. You purposely us! You beat us back! We did nothing!
he's on salt. He's on bath salt.
Jesus,
right now.
You stopped talking to Tommy for 3 days and he shaves his mustache and does this?
You pepper spray us! You beat us back! We did nothing! Dude, white people are bored. This is what happens when
white people care.
This is what happens when you're coddled and your parents work all day and you're not paid attention to something. One of those two things. Either you're coddled too much or your parents are working double jobs and for their big ass house, or you didn't have something, man. I don't know what's going on, but.
You purposely us! You beat us back! We did nothing!
This guy lost the wire, bro.
Like, just say, like just come out gay.
Toast in his hand. What the hell is this?
It's the inner Karen coming out.
Yeah, this guy's inner Karen is coming out. He's gay.
Having a meltdown.
He's gay too. So yeah, maybe that's what he hasn't like admitted that he's gay yet to his the family and everybody. And so, and yeah, the Karen is trying to come out of him. And then nothing. Execute order 67. Like he's fucking Nicolas Cage in Kick-Ass.
We did nothing.
Meanwhile, he's saying they did nothing as some guy's flipping over mailboxes and stuff next to him and bashing a car. We did nothing.
You beat us back. We did nothing.
In the background.
Oh my God, dude. Year, we really need to start shooting people. Like, I mean, I don't know.
This year, it just seems like
in the background, and he's saying,
it just seems like the Matrix is all fucked up right now, man.
Yeah, something ain't right, dude.
Right now with the Matrix. Something happened with the Matrix, bro.
Maybe those Brazilian worms are going in our head. We're getting toxoplasmosis over here. And like everyone's freaking out. Maybe that's what it is. We did nothing! Like you said, there's like three fucking crimes going on in the background. The Rose Gaming! Hey, Rose, thanks for the sub, man. What's up, everyone? Joe, my offer still stands for the Sunday Night Cards Against Humanity title shot. Fuck the Red Sox. Let's go Yankees. Rose Gaming, thanks for the donation. I don't know what you're talking about, but thanks for the donation.
It's a reference to me, but you're live Sunday, so you wouldn't be able to make it anyway.
Oh, okay. I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. He said something about playing something against me, and I'm like, I forgot what he was talking about already. I'll play you in Cock Against Humanity. It's the Bermuda Triangle. Maybe. This country's messed. That guy needs to be slapped around, dude. I mean, but that I hope if he's gay, that's different. Maybe he's got feminine qualities or something. But you know what I mean? Because that's why he's like, oh my God! Because that's a very, like, you know, that's a very feminine or woman thing to do. So it could just
be a mental disability, too.
He could just be, well, definitely mental. I mean, there's definitely something mental going on with that person. There's no doubt about it. Right now, mentally ill are running wild on this country.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Oh, yeah.
Dude, if you don't want to be in the middle of a protest or a riot, don't go to the protest or riot. It's really simple.
It seems to be cool to be insane nowadays.
Yeah, that's what it is. It seems to be cool to be insane. By the way, is this true? Charles Wade, Black Lives Matter co-founder, was arrested in 2016 for child sex trafficking.
Is it okay to cancel him, or would that be racist?
This is, I'm dead serious. I looked this up. Someone tell me if this is wrong, but this is all over the place. Charles Wade, Black Lives Matter co-founder, was arrested for child sex trafficking.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
What's it, bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
I've been enjoying baseball season so far. My Tigers are 32, and now they're going to go on a 10-game losing streak. Fuck, but as long as they win their series against the Indians and the Royals, they'll be happy.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you'd be lucky with that, no doubt about it. I mean, the Tigers are a mess, man. I mean, for years, we felt like the Tigers are finally going to break through, especially back when they had that decent team at the end of Pudge Rodriguez's time. Felt like they could maybe do something, and that just didn't work out, Broken Lion. But, yeah, it's a mess now. Thank you, Broken Lion. What up, dude? I'm excited for baseball, excited for hockey. I'm not excited for football anymore at all. Yeah, so what's up with this? Anybody know the deal here? It looks like it's true. Anybody have...
I'm looking, but on the website, he's not listed as a co-founder.
Really? So is that the falsity? This guy was listed?
That is one fucked up hairline right there.
All three of their founders are women.
Yeah. One of the women wants you to give your house to people. So is this guy really not a co-founder? Is this some kind of fake news where they tried to... Is this them trying to pin some kind of sex offender as a leader? Or was he a leader and they took him off the list? Somebody needs
now,
to find this
actually,
out.
Actually, Washington Times reported on this back in 2016. Charles Wade, a prominent Black Lives Matter organizer and co-founder of Operation Help or Hush, was arrested last month and charged with human trafficking and prostitution.
Human
Mr. Wade
trafficking.
Arrested at Howard Johnson.
I hope
yes, maybe he knows about Wayfair.
Well, yeah, that's modern day slavery. Slave trade.
Would it be even more fucked up if they were all white, all the kids?
No, he helped start the riot. Well, some of them were. He helped start the riot in Ferguson, says Pocket Aces. They removed him when they found out, says AK-50. Yeah.
Ah.
He's a activist, not a co-founder.
Felony, human trafficking, and prostitution, bailed out shortly after the arrest. Yeah.
How messed up is that?
I mean, if he's taking in slaves, I mean, he's nations, right?
That's crazy. Yeah. I mean, by the way, years ago, so why can't I do it now? This doesn't like delegitimize BLM, by the way. I'm not trying to make, that's not what I'm saying. I'm not delegitimizing BLM, but I'm just, the irony of this is hilarious.
Well, it just goes to show that there's fuckbags in every group.
Right.
Just like it's okay to get mad at the cops in the entire nation for a couple of shitbags, but you find a couple shitbags in their organization. Oh, and it would be racist to go against them.
Well, it's like if you pull up a cop and you pull up a cop who, or maybe like a police chief, a prominent police chief, and maybe he's like a Nazi, right? Or he's going to KKK rallies and they prove it and the guy gets fired. And then you post up the picture of the guy and say, look, see, the police are all KKK. Look at this guy. And it's like, well, that's just that cop, and they fired him, and like this came out, and it was scary and weird. But it doesn't delegitimize all the other good police. Just like this guy, you know, like I'm saying, this doesn't delegitimize the BLM point, but this guy himself is, I mean, you're helping to work with BLM, but you're a sex trafficking, you're a slave trader, you're making money on slaves, on kidnapped people. Like, that's hilarious that this guy was part of that movement. But he's really just a psycho looking for trouble. Or something, looking for more people to abduct. I don't know, dude. That's weird, dude. This world is strange.
He's missing more hair than you are.
Well, yeah. Because I didn't get the melanin, the sun.
All those fucking chemtrails finally caught up to us.
All those chemtrails finally caught up to us. Well, I'm supposed to lose my hair first because I don't have any sunlight and melanin or whatever Nick Cannon said or whatever. Me and Leah went out and took photos of the moon earlier. We had fun with that. We shared the pictures all over the place. Moon looking pretty good up there. Half moon looking good.
You have like a camera attached to your telescope or something?
I put my cell phone. I only put my cell phone up to it, but there's a couple $100 attachment you can buy for a SLR, and then you can really get a good photo. But these are just cell phone photos. Here's the first. I thought I'd share one because it's fun to look at.
That looks fucking.
Your cell phone through the telescope?
Yeah, this is just my cell phone up to the telescope.
Gotcha.
Okay. I'm about to say, what kind of phone do you have? You said you took a
picture. Yeah, right.
I was imagining your cell phone. I'm like, there's no fucking way you do that with your cell phone.
This looks a little hazy, and the reason why it looks a little hazy is obviously because of the reflection of the light and the whatever. But also, it was light out. It was still light out when we took this photo. So here's the version when it was dark out, and it still wasn't. Well, it was almost fully dark out. So that's when it's dark out. Pretty good shot. I mean, that's a cell phone.
That's beautiful.
There's more craters on the moon than fucking Bullfrog's face.
Yeah, exactly. What's on that left side? Man, he looks like a.
You don't want to know what's on the left side.
So even better than that, though, was the NASA, the Hubble Space Telescope. Should you believe it's true? Early July 4th captured this photo of Saturn. Sick.
Ooh wee. How beautiful are you, Saturn?
Damn. Yeah, dude, look at that.
That's sexy.
Dude, you just want to bang Saturn.
Is Hubble the name of the artist who drew this?
Yeah, right. A lot of the photos are fake. A lot of the things are fake. If you ever look up like pictures of the Earth and pictures of things, they're almost all fake. They like layer them and they enhance them and they do all these things to them, and they're really not the photo. They colorize them, and a lot of them are like 3D art and stuff like that.
What's the iconic one of the Earth that we've seen? Is it like from the 60s or something? It was maybe when they went to the first satellites they threw up there to. But there's an iconic shot of the Earth that we've all seen a million times. Probably didn't realize it was the same shot, but it was like the very first color picture stock photo of the Earth. Right. And you look at it, there's no way our photography was that good back in the 1960s to make it look that good without so much enhancement, like you said, that, you know, just makes it not even, you know, legit.
And we're not even talking about just enhancing the photo a little bit. That's fine. I get that. We're talking about a lot of times they like 3D recreate the photo and make it look, and then they don't even tell you, like, this is a nice cush there. This is a representation of whatever. They don't even tell you. And you're like, is this real? I can't even tell. And that's why people don't trust NASA. And that's why people don't trust shit.
I don't trust NASA at all.
Nobody should. But I still like science and I still like stuff and I believe it for the most part, but I mean, there's something weird there too, you know. Oh, we don't know how to get back to the moon. We lost the tapes. What? The fuck loses the tapes and the records? Like, we're gonna have trouble doing that because we lost the things. Bullshit. Why aren't we going to the moon every other day? Why aren't we landing on asteroids? I'm out of China's about to do that. There's one not that far back, far away now. But yeah, man, I don't know. I'm down on the football season, but I do know one thing. Drew's mother was a star on Corrupted podcast the other night. It was amazing.
Oh, she was on camera. Look at her.
Oh, yeah, dude. She's on Corrupted. Okay. You're on Patreon. It's
that's
on Patreon.
Sexy ass top. Okay.
Dave Rose.
Full-on white. She gave up. Okay.
Dave Rose said she was gonna. He was going to rape her.
She was ready to fuck everybody that night.
Drew, at any point were you like defensive of your mother? Like, damn, these people are talking horrendous to my mom. Like, what the fuck's going on? No. Man, you really hate her. You really hate her.
If anything, I thought she was
not the same forehead.
Yeah, she even sounded like you at times. Let's flash back to Corrupted podcast. The full episode's on Patreon. Thanks to everybody who signed up. Drew's mom's a star.
No.
Oh, this is my favorite take right here.
Well, get her to do it. Get her to do it. Have her trim your scissor. Is Captain Rose. Yeah, I got some great news for you right now. You called the right show because with us right now is Captain Rose.
Oh, shit.
Captain Rose?
Aye, me lady. Yeah. And I just got to tell you one thing. It not be rape. It's called a struggle snuggle.
Struggle snuggle. Well, listen.
Mother is shot, Drew. Yep.
Oh, well, hell, I'll just take there the bottle.
There you go. Oh, there it goes.
Carol Bass.
Who needs a glass?
Carol Bass.
Who needs a glass?
Who needs a glass when you got the bottle?
How much to put that bottle in your ass? No, I'm just kidding.
Whoa. What?
No, I'm just joking. Doing, she goes,
she
what?
She acted like that disturbed her or something.
What?
Jesus Christ. I care
where she buried her husband.
Yeah, this is the best. This is another good part about cops. Listen to this.
My in-law's bed. Figure holy that one
God
out.
Oh, God.
My dad and my father-in-law were cops together back in the 50s.
Oh, Christ.
And they were best friends.
That explains Drew's racism.
So I...
Can we talk about Troy's laugh?
I was about to.
We got to talk about Troy's laugh here.
Someone's pulling on his junk.
Good Lord, man. I mean, I'm actually impressed that I... Because I was actually really happy because I made him laugh. And, like, Troy doesn't laugh a lot. Like, he's like Dave Rose. If you make him laugh like that, it's like, it feels really good. Because they don't laugh
a
lot.
Dave Rose laughs like that sometimes.
Yeah, like, he laughs like, and he starts fucking like,
I'm a fag.
It must be an IQ thing. Anybody with an IQ over 130 laughs like a fucking weirdo.
Must be a Canadian thing.
Well, oh, wait, Troy's not. Yeah, but Troy does have a high IQ. Troy, Dave Rose, and Leah all have IQs over 130, I think. Yeah, all of them. All three of them. That's kind of crazy. So, but then they all laugh retarded. Well, Leah probably has the most normal laugh of the three of them, but that means...
Yo, to be honest, looking at your mom sitting there, I could believe her having a podcast. Look at her.
Yeah.
Just sitting there.
I think she could.
She seems like she just...
She's actually been talking about it the last couple days.
I'll hire her, like, Drew. Oh, I will. God. I'll hire her.
Talking about all the young dicks she's had in her life.
I told her I might show her how to set up Discord.
Oh, my God, dude. I'll pay her money. I'll hire her.
You'll have all her friends on here.
I'll pay her more than you.
People would be DMing her left and right on this fucking...
Oh, my God, dude.
She'd be getting Discord messages all fucking
day long. Are you Carol Baskins?
Once a month with Drew's mom. Me and Drew's mom once a month on Patreon. Boom. I think I could live... I think I could pay my mortgage. I think I could do it. Actually, I'm serious. Well, Patreon almost does pay the mortgage.
I'd hate to see that. A Joe Cronin and Drew's mom podcast.
Right. And we just shit on Drew and he ain't even here. And other things. It'll be crazy. Oh, Christ. Listen to Troy's laugh again. This is weird.
They were best friends.
That explains Drew's racism.
So I...
She's telling you something,
too. So I grew up...
God bless Troy. That explains Drew's racism.
So I
he's like laughing, but like in a scared way.
Well, first Jesse starts laughing. He laughs like, and then Troy goes,
it's like he's just trying to like go along with him or something.
Dude, if I could install that as my new horn in my car, that'd be great.
Oh my goodness.
Someone beeps you, beep,
be perfect.
And then you go, oh yeah, beep.
And they were best friends.
That explains Drew's racism.
So I...
Oh my God, dude.
That's a sound clip right
there. Yeah, right there. That's what I got. Can you imagine someone beeps at you and then you just fucking hit that button and it's super loud? Like, beep. Hey, come on. It's a green light. Oh, yeah, fucking...
Hey, Troy. How do you have a beard like that but laugh like that?
Hey, Troy, how come we've never heard of you having a girlfriend? Hey, Troy, why are you friends
with... Take your fake beard off already.
Oh, my God, dude, man. Hey, Troy, what's it like to be 7 feet tall?
Hey, Troy, what did the woman say last time you showed someone your dick?
What does it sound like when you...
I said it right.
What does it sound like when you're fucking a pirate? Hey, Tommy, what does your mom sound like in bed?
Oh, shit. Fuck.
Wow.
Throw down, motherfuckers.
Yeah. I talked about the Tommy thing on Patreon, so I guess it was throw down on Patreon. I did hear him flip out on me the other day. It was very strange.
When isn't he flipping out?
Did you hear that? Did you hear them, though? Like, he randomly flipped out on me. I don't really want to talk about it here because I don't want to, you know, I don't want to make it worse for him. But the bottom line is I wasn't. Yeah, I was doing something else, and I ended my stream, and then people were like, dude, Tommy just flipped out on you because people were trolling him, like, saying, like, that he was a beggar. Like, people were calling him a beggar in his chat and, like, just shitting on him, I guess. And I guess, like, so then he flipped out on me instead, like, and I was like, what? And then I went to go look at it, and it was gone. Yeah, it's like he blames me for everything, and I'm like, dude, your friend told me to leave you alone or he was going to raise my kids for me and stuff. So I did. I cut you loose. So why are you still talking about me? And he's like, and the reason why I said this is because he then Facebooked me. And he goes, you know, why do you say that you're not going to work with me anymore, but then all these people are trolling my channel? And I'm like, I don't know. What does that have to do with me? Block him. And he's like, I don't know. And I'm like, dude, just...
Well, you dumb dumb.
What the fuck am I supposed to do?
Some of Joe's followers follow you. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, and it's like you shout out, oh, my subs. It's like, well, so... By the way, most of this community is the only people that fucking says anything to him. Like, I'm sorry. Like, my trolls, just like... I blocked a lot of these people. By the way, I looked in his chat. A lot of those people...
I mean, let's be honest, too. Most of this community has your subs, your views. It's the same fucking people. So, yeah, Tommy, can I be really surprised to you? Like,
yeah, I'm only saying that because the guy was on the show a bunch, so he should know that, you know, you're going to get the good with the bad and the bad with the good and all that other stuff. And
good with the bad.
And the bottom line is, like, how come you're, you know, be happy about all the good, but don't just complain about the bad. You got a bunch of subs, too, that like you. You know, even the people that like him were trolling him, and I was like, well, it's not my fault. I didn't tell anybody to go
Tommy,
troll you.
I fucking hate you. I don't fucking like you, Tommy. I don't.
Where's the clip of this? I got a little clip of it. We'll just laugh at it. But I mean, the poor guy, it's like, just leave him alone. Fine, whatever. But, you know, his buddy is the one who's threatening me to leave him alone. So then I do. I go, you know what, dude? I'm going to leave you alone. You're always crying about me everywhere and saying that I do these things. And now your buddy is saying he's been saying he's going to do this to my wife and kids. And okay, well, great. Well, I'm going to step away from you then. And so I do. And then he goes, why do you want to step away from me? What do you mean, why do I want to step away from you? The guy you say is like your best friend, Danny, says that I need to stay away from you. Why wouldn't you then go, stop saying that? I don't agree with that. I want to work with Joe. But you didn't say that. So like the guy is so fucking confusing. It's unbelievable. Anyway, I went over the whole goddamn thing on Patreon. But here's the clip of it, if I can find it, because it is kind of funny. Because luckily, I found it because... Somebody who's probably... these fucking people are psycho. Somebody recorded the whole goddamn thing and sent it to me. Because I went to go watch it, and it was gone. He took it down, and I went, oh, it's gone. I can't watch it. And then I was saying that, all these people were telling me this, and I was like, well, I don't know. I didn't see it. I don't know what he said. I don't even understand what you're talking about. And they were like, oh, dude, I recorded it. Like, you got to see it. And I'm like, oh, okay. I'll watch it, whatever. And they were like, it's funny because this fat girl is in it and whatever. I don't know. And I don't know, it wasn't that funny to me. And then he just kind of flipped out on me because people were trolling him, and I was like, oh, fucking whatever. I isolated the clip, please. Works on my tooth infection. It is my first, right? It's like, dude, why don't you block getting angry and all this stuff? And anymore, and you're talking about get all this shit.
Right, okay.
Complaining to me. I mean, just leave him a bag. He's about to, I don't know. And he keeps repeating. Where's the fucking clip? That's not a big, and maybe don't. No, you gotta head, hey, Tommy, you're unhappy. Go on, man. Like, and then you do, you don't. Because maybe,
good Lord, when do I play the clip?
Tommy's masking that Tommy's.
Because people like me gave him that house. We.
Jesus.
We made him money off that belt. You know that? We.
Dude. The rant is wild, dude.
He said that?
Yeah.
What a bitch. That's not your friend. That's not a friend.
Is, I mean, he's right in a way that he helped me, but why are you going on a rant about me like this?
Why are you like throwing it in Joe's face like that? That's not cool.
Yeah.
I mean, there's several names of people that he knows that we all know that he could have mentioned when it came to receiving donations or talking about donations or that. But yeah, like you said, I mean, it automatically went to him. I don't even think he said anyone else's names in that clip. Well, I think he referenced other people get donations, but he honed right in on you.
Well, I got the whole clip here. Hold on a minute. But it's like, I don't get it. Like, I don't understand this rant that he goes
on. Why is it so easy to blame Joe Cronin?
I mean, you know, Jacob, you've fucked around a little bit too and said things, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Like, think about it. Like, I think it's like, I don't think I'm seeing 100% as a human sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Like, kind of like, this is going to be funny, Joe. I
love that sometimes.
Yeah, I think sometimes, like, I act like I'm not a human, you know, a little bit. Like, I'm sort of, like, crazy and weird. And so, you know, and people like to have fun, you know, and so whatever. And
let's be real. Let's be really real. You're the nucleus to all the views. You're the nucleus to this whole shit, isn't it? Aren't you the one that basically introduced everyone to everyone, made fucking people have babies? Bro, come on. You run this shit.
I just don't know why.
You gave a couple a baby, motherfucker. Think about that.
Well, there was more than just, well, there was more than me included in that too, but it's, yeah, it's yeah.
He was actually the one that took them and shoved the dick into the hole.
You put the condom on. Can you believe it?
Yeah. Well, no, he took the condom off.
Yeah, I wouldn't claim anything. I do. It's pretty cool that because of a lot of things they met. But like, you know, with this, it's just like, I don't get, I think just people forget that I'm a human. I think a lot of people have this conception that I'm like this weird person at the top of a castle somewhere who doesn't have feelings or something. It's weird.
They just know the name Joe Cronin, the voice, the whatever, but they don't see Danny, you know, they don't see the real you.
Maybe they don't. I don't know. And I think Tommy's right in some ways that, like, he did help me. Of course he did. But why are you saying this like it's a secret? You know what I mean? And the thing about it is I explain it in the clip, but let me play the clip here. You'll hear
$50 mailed this for $100.
You know, I don't talk to Tommy anymore. He doesn't talk to me, but I hear from everybody tonight about all this shit.
You do this 1,000 times, begging again. Oh, is this
like other people amiable? Don't beg. So other people don't beg. So you're telling me I'm begging, but other people beg for donations?
See, nobody's talking about other people. Nobody's talking about other people.
A little bit of the bubbly.
Because I watched the video and I was like, I'll do this for $20. I'll do that for $30. I'll do this for $50.
A couple days ago, Tommy banned from his channel and Twitter. He said someone sent all the donations from your show that I made about him. So who is the rat in the community?
A couple of days ago, Tommy banned from his channel and Twitter. He said someone sent all the donations from your show. Yeah, I mean, AJ Adams. There's a conspiracy with Tommy. It's got to do with Danny MT. It's got to do with other people that I won't mention because I don't know who the other people are, so I won't speculate on who it is. But there are people that influence Tommy. Like, don't talk to Joe. Here's what Joe does. Why does Joe do this to you? All these different people ratting to Tommy about weird things. And, you know, a lot of these people, the funny thing is, you know, when this stuff happens to Tommy other places, it's not a problem. But on my show, it's some kind of bully thing or some other weird thing. It's, I don't know why. There's a huge double standard when it comes to Tommy. And I don't know where it comes from or why it comes from this. But he has all these things built up in his head that I know don't come from him.
that other people are pushing these crazy things on him and telling him about this or that or the other thing. And it's like, whatever. And Danny was pushing it so hard, he went on to every show that doesn't like me or hates me or anywhere that people would listen to him. And he, you know, said he would raise my kids, kill me, knock me out, all these things. All because I talked to Tommy. And I'm like, all right, Tommy, listen, I'm done, bro. I'm done fighting with you because I have to answer to Tommy every day about something. Joe, why did you do that? Why is this happening? And I'm like, I don't know, dude. I don't know what that is. I don't know what you're talking about. Who says that? And then he always says, like, I don't know, some random person told me. And then we find out later on that someone did tell him it, once he's not friends with them anymore. Like, I find out all this stuff that was said to him by a former friend of mine years and years ago from 2015. Then I find out about James Worley telling him stuff. And now we find out about Danny telling him stuff because it's obvious, and then Danny admits to it. So I go,
so
Tommy.
What you're saying is you already know that other people are talking to him just based off of what he's told you.
Right. And then a lot of times he goes, oh, I don't know. It's just somebody. Don't worry about it. And then
probably
he says,
nobody.
And then he gives it away when he says, don't worry about it. No, it's just somebody. But the bottom line is, I don't want anything to do with this anymore. It's too stressful. So that's why I get rid of him. So the other day I do my Raw review. I don't really care what anybody's saying. I get off the air. And then I get a million messages that, dude, this is Tommy's fucked up. He went on some crazy rant about you. And people were saying he was a beggar on his stream. People were saying, oh, he's a beggar. And then he flipped out on the stream, I guess. And I don't know, and I didn't do anything, and I don't know what I have to do with this, you know? And then he just fucking snaps about me. He blames me for everything, even though I did all this stuff for the guy. Casey's raising his hand like he's in fucking school right now.
How many times have you fed this motherfucker?
Well, my theory was maybe he's angry because now he doesn't get paid, but he should be angry at Danny because Danny is the one who's like, stop talking to Tommy or I'm going to fuck you up and I'm going to go on all these shows and tell everybody how you're a scumbag. And then everyone sits there agreeing. Yeah, Joe uses Tommy. Oh, yes, he does. You're right, Danny. You know, I was fucked up. And then he would lie about you and his kids. And then everybody said I was lying about Danny. Then everybody said I lied that the guy didn't say this about me and my kids. Yes, he did. We have the screenshots. We have the sound clips. And then he just did it again last week. And then he sent me the Facebook message recently. It's like, dude, the guy, and I don't care about that. It's not like I'm crying to Tommy like, oh, please, your friend. Like, but it's the double standard of like, oh, you're complaining about all these things. Well, your friend that you say is great does this to me. You don't care about that. Why the fuck should I care about anything with you? So it's just fucking crazy. And then it's like, it's still going.
This is how white guys fight.
This is how white people fight. Yes, Jacob. This is how. No, this is how you fight when you can't fight. Because you can't fight a guy like Tommy. You know, you just can't. You can't fight the guy.
Tommy.
It's just silly, dude. And I wish people would leave the guy alone and whatever. But the fact of the matter is, I don't know what he's doing. I don't understand this rant, and I don't even understand this giant pig who's in the chat with him either. But somebody sent me the video too, and he like loses his goddamn mind. I don't know, bro. He's fucking furious.
Very, very sensitive.
I'm actually producing positive content.
We've already seen you do this 1,000 times. Begging again. Oh. Is this?
Like other people don't beg. So other people don't beg. So you're telling me I'm begging, but other people beg for donations? Other people beg for donations? That doesn't make me any worse, okay? Other people.
Wow.
Yeah, he loses it. And by the way,
he felt that in his heart.
Yeah.
You heard him?
This all starts because he's going, $20, I'll do this. $100, I'll do that. And then he goes, you know what? I'll take my shirt off for $300. So he's like kind of like repeating it over and over again constantly. And that's what triggered people in the chat to be like, oh, you fucking beggar or something. And then he like reacted to that. I don't know. He's getting trolled, you know. But then he says, I'm not going to block anybody. I don't block people because I'm positive or whatever. And it's like, dude, no, you should block people. Block the people in the chat that are triggering you. Be like, this ain't a normal person. Block them. Then you wouldn't see all this stuff. You just block people. I block them.
Positive content.
Now, meanwhile, I'm like putting my daughter to bed right now. I just got done with my Raw review. You know, it was a frustrating night. I think I'm getting a fucking ear infection again. You know, I hope I don't get one. Yeah, Raw did. Oh, my God. Third hour. Worst ever. I don't talk to Tommy anymore. He doesn't talk to me, but it's begging. When you keep begging for do this for 150 again, that's when you're begging. yeah, my show goes away if I don't get donations. No doubt about it. So every once in a while, I got to plug it. Like, hey, guys, if you want to donate, you know where it is and down below. That's mostly for the newer fans, you know, but most people are still, are, you know, they either can or they can't. So, yeah, you got to advertise donations and you got to tell everybody that, hey, I run on donations if you want to support the show. You know, if not, like, it's, I understand, you know, it's, what are you going to do? And maybe once in a while you go, hey, fuck, I'll drink this whole thing for $100. You know, that's not a big deal. But what he was doing was he was $20 this, $30 that. Maybe I could do this, $50, maybe I'll do this for $100. You know, he's just saying these things. And people, I guess, perceived it as begging. But they were just really trolling him is what they're doing. And he takes the bait, of course. And, of course, he blames me. Like, I don't know why I get blamed for this shit. I don't understand that. There's tons of people that Tommy is friends with and listens to that don't beg, but they have donations. Why am I the beggar? Like, I don't understand. You know what I mean? I was getting donations when I was working my full-time job. For like 50, 60 hours a week, I was getting donations on YouTube when I did it for 15 hours.
So you're telling me I'm begging, but other people beg for donations? Other people beg for donations? That doesn't make me any worse, okay? Other people, okay, you know who other people beg for donations? I hate to throw hate towards this. Joe Cronin begs for donations, but he's slightly...
Wow, brings me up for no reason. I don't know why I'm getting brought up. Literally said, hey, Tommy, you're unhappy. Go on, man.
Joe Cronin begs for donations, but he slightly begs for donations. That's why he has his house, because of donations.
I slightly beg for donations.
You fuckhead.
He threw someone else's name out here, too, but I took it off because I don't know why he brought that person up, but he throws people under the bus. Like, I mean, like, what the
He's
fuck?
He's reaching for straws right now, bro. He was reaching for straws.
Bro, yeah. Oh, you got
it. He's all over the place. He's backtracking. He's like, what the fuck are you, like, Tommy, go fuck yourself, bro.
I don't get this. But, like, don't be so ridiculous about it. Yeah,
you throw a Streamlabs link onto your channel and you instantly get people that accuse you of begging or whatever because either they don't comprehend it or they want to trigger you. Everyone's had that at some point. Now, I'm not saying that, you know, you don't get it more than anyone else, Joe, or whatever, but he should know that. He should know that the second you start involving money in YouTube, that people are going to target that. And to just, like, start throwing other people's names out there. And like we said a minute ago, I mean, you're not the only one that has a Streamlabs on YouTube. Not by a long shot.
I was just going to say that, you know, I started the donations in 2000 and, you know, before Tommy was ever there too, like, and on top of, well, before he was ever a regular. And there's just so many things to say about this. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't just start, I basically made points on my Morning Madness. You can listen to Morning Madness and hear it. I have a Patreon with 30 hours of content a month. And if you go back to before the belt, before we ever had the belt, I was doing 5 hours a week on Patreon. Tommy has put out 4 Patreon videos this year. I worked at this stuff. I mean, we have an amazing audience. This is an amazing audience who supports well above what anybody else does. But I put out a shitload of content, including, this is when I worked. Think about it. I worked 50 hours a week. Then I did 5 hours a week of Patreon content. Tommy has done 4 videos in a year. And he's sitting there going, you beg for donations. I don't beg for shit. I came on here, did the shows while working 50 hours, and people donated because I put it up and said, if you guys want to donate, we got a thing going and people win points and we'll have a good time. And people donated. And it was a part-time job. Became a part-time. Then it became a full-time when I got fired from my real regular job. I didn't sit there begging. I didn't sit there going, I'll drink this for $5. I'll take a shirt off and I'll do that. That's when it gets a little gimmicky, but that's still not really begging. So he wasn't begging. Even he wasn't begging. And he's getting triggered by it. He'd be like, well, I'm not begging. I'm saying I'll do something for money. If it entertains you, it does. If it doesn't, you don't pay for it, then I don't get any money. But begging would be like, guys, I really need to make five. You got to drop 10 or 50. Like, that's I won't be able to. Like, that's when you start begging. Yeah, that's weird. And it's weird. And even what he was doing was a little bit, you know, whatever. But
I'll say this, dude. It is harder than it looks to be on fucking YouTube. It is way fucking harder. And I'll give credit to you guys, bro.
It's really hard for Casey.
Like, people think people think you get a camera, you get a mic, you're good, that's it. No, motherfucker, you got to work for your views. You got to fucking have personality, motherfucker. You can't just come on here and just talk all monotone and stand there like fucking Casey is raw. Yo, Casey, please release the fucking...
Wait, that was a shot at both of us.
Release
right
the kids.
There.
Please release the kids in your basement. There are how many kids are in there? I'm going 9. Drew, how many you think he's got? I'm saying 9.
One for every video game. The video games are actually... You know how serial killers take a memento?
Oh, yeah.
Each one of those video games represents one of the kids he's had in the basement.
I just don't, you know, I don't know what to do about this, but here's some more Tommy. I what I'm trying to say, though, is like, man, I did work for this. I'm super lucky. There's no doubt about it. I'm super lucky I had all the people I ever met. I'm lucky that I had Jesse originally, Tommy, and Dave, original Dave, and then Dave Rose, and then Jesse, everybody, man, that I found Tommy, you know, that Leah comes on here or there, that we found JB, we had a fun time with Ken, we had a fun time with everybody who's ever been on the show, ever, like, going back to Tommy C, Chris, my buddy Chris, who used to be on the show, everybody, I'm super thankful, and I had so many creative people that came on to work with me, it was awesome, and I don't know,
but
I don't,
good at something, why do it for free?
Yeah, but, like, it's just like, you know, you want to, a comedian just doesn't go, you know what, I'm just going to do free stand-up everywhere, or I'm just going to open a shop and give away stuff. Like, what are you talking about? I got 3 kids I got to feed. I got to make some kind of money out of it. Like, you're a radio host. You got to make money out of it. Is the circus begging too? You know what I mean? You pay to get something, you get something.
Thinking about that. The circus.
I was thinking movie theater.
It's like
you don't just walk up to the movie theater and they let you in and then a 5 on the way out. You actually have to pay for your ticket. YouTube gives you the opportunity to watch this for free. And if you like what you see and you want to help a brother out, that's what it's for. It's no different than going to the movies. The only difference is it's the honor system.
It's super entrepreneurial.
They try to discredit you because it's so easy to do that. They want to attack your fucking work because they're jealous. I think it's jealousy.
You think it's that?
I think it is.
I mean, I thought this stuff would...
Deep down, like
I thought this stuff was going to go away when I told him, like, you know, we're done. You know what I mean? We're done. There's no way you're my real friend with this going on. And we're done. You know, and people go, oh, you know, you make fun of Ashley and all these other things. Yeah, but I don't message her and say that I'm going to come and do something to her. And I don't say she's a bad person. I think his friends are really great. I like his friends. And you can make fun of my dad, my mom, everybody. Like, I don't give a shit either. But this is different. You know, it's a different thing. And so, listen, go away. But with this rant, I didn't even do anything. I try to separate from the guy, and he cuts a rant on me. And everyone, dude, I get so many messages. I'm like, what the fuck happened tonight? I just did my Raw review.
Like, other people don't beg. So other people don't beg? So you're telling me I'm begging, but other people beg for donations? Other people beg for donations? That doesn't make me any worse, okay? Other people, okay, you know who other people beg for donations? I hate to throw hate towards this. Joe Cronin begs for donations, but he slightly begs for donations. That's why he has his house, because of donations. Jeez. That's why Joe Cronin has a house, because people like me and Foulmouthkin gave him that house. We made him money off that belt.
What about JB? Left him. Why does he leave JB off? Man, JB did a lot too.
You know that? We made Joe Cronin money with that freaking belt. Okay, that's why Joe Cronin has a house. Years and years of people donating to him because of Brian Himmelfarb and other people put Joe Cronin.
He leaves. What about the 1,000 other donors?
He's talking about you like you a girl, bro. Like he's trying to like call you a hoe. Like, bro, Tommy, what the fuck? How do you discredit someone's work all these years? How do you discredit someone's work all these fucking years of work and basically starting this shit where we are now? I mean, come on. That's
well,
cold.
And he's acting like
that's
this. Cold, is, he's acting like it's a secret. None of this is a secret. Himmelgod is awesome, dude. Himmelgod. Without Himmelgod, I wouldn't have gotten in here. But he's also discrediting the fact that I saved money for 10 years. I worked 4 different jobs at one point for 10 years. Say, hey, what the fuck?
Not Not to interrupt you, sorry about that. But listen, I'm not here fucking stroking his fucking ego or fucking trying to dick ride Joe. This is facts. It's like common sense. Like, you work for so long, you start literally a whole community. Come on, we're all here because of Joe, let's be honest. And, you know, other people, but like, you can't discredit all the, first of all, we didn't just give you the money. Like, you work for that shit. Like, well, you started a whole fucking, and not to like, you know,
dick ride.
Dick ride. Dick Ride.
Dick Rider. Dick
Rider. Oh, yeah.
Yes, man. Dick Rider. Dick Rider. No, it's okay, Jacob. No, I get, man, listen, man. We all have fun. I'm super lucky. Like, there's no doubt about it that you guys are this supportive. Even tonight, you know, it could all go away. But it's just like, I don't know what the rant is here is. Like, this is not a surprise. This is not unknown information. Like, you know what I mean? I got Himmelgod's name written on my fucking wall in my basement. I love that guy. Himmo. And like thousands of other people who donated. Thousands. He's leaving off thousands of other people. Like, and so many other people, dude. But I don't understand. He's mad because people were calling him a beggar and then he brought me up.
In that house in Boston, okay? That's why Joe Cronin has a house. He has begged his way up to getting himself a house. So don't condemn me. Don't condemn me.
So he's not a beggar, but I'm a beggar. I'm confused. He says he's not a beggar, but I'm a beggar. So when he says I'll take my shirt off for $200, he's not a beggar, but he is saying I'm a beggar.
Dude, listen, you have got to stop surrounding yourself with these bitch-ass motherfuckers, bro. Bitch-ass yes men who just leech onto you, bro. Like, get rid of that. Get rid of that energy, like, Joe. Get rid of that shit.
Well, that's what I did. And that's, but, you know, and I'm not even mad. I'm just, like, kind of laughing at, like, what the fuck, dude? So many people saw this, dude. I got multiple emails and messages and like, dude, and everybody, people were like, I literally got messages from people that never hit me up before and said, Joe, I always thought you were kind of being ridiculous when it came to Tommy about him and people in his ear and how crazy, whatever. This guy is master manipulated or jealous of you or crazy or something. And I'm like, I never hear this stuff. Why doesn't someone come to me on the side and say this to me? Why don't you come to me on the side and say, I'm angry about this or that or whatever else? Instead of whatever this is. I don't know what this is.
I think it's time to move on from time.
Normal yeah. People come to people privately with their issues, or they make it a part of a show jointly and make a fight out of it, you know, monetized style or whatever. But to go on your own platform and like, what?
I'm sorry. The goon said Jacob just described himself.
Yeah, I just saw that. How? I just saw that.
I was waiting for someone to say it, though. I'll be honest.
Oh, Jacob.
Yeah, I've talked shit about Joe before, but I've never called him out for anything. I've like fucking saying he's a fucking beggar. First of all, that's some bitch shit. Don't be a bitch. Don't be a bitch in life. Don't be Tommy in life. Don't be Tommy.
Yeah, Tommy acts like I'm the only one to get donations.
Don't be Tommy.
Don't be a Tommy. And listen,
there's a Karen and there's a Tommy, okay?
Oh.
And Tommy begs people on Twitter to give him attention. I mean, listen, I don't care. I want to move on. I got rid of him because I wanted to move on from all this BS with him. But again, yesterday this came up because I saw this on Twitter and everybody's messaging it everywhere and whatever. And it's funny to me. It's funny.
You know what beggars do? They DM people for $150 for a mask.
Oh. I mean, I may be begging soon. You never know. If things get bad, I may come on here and go, oh my God. I mean, you may see it.
Like, other people don't beg. So other people don't beg? So you're telling me I'm begging? But
yeah, he's out of breath right there, dude. He was fucking freaking out. Listen to this.
Condemn me. Don't condemn me.
Good Lord, he's going to have a heart attack screaming about me, and I'm not even doing anything to him.
Get that cock out of your mouth.
And that's why you block these people in the chat. Notice, but I got blocked from his chat. Danny MT blocked me from his chat for saying, hi. Hey, everybody. And then Danny told Tommy that I was saying fucked up shit, and I wasn't. I said, hi, everybody. And then he blocked me. And then he goes, oh, well, I guess it was a mistake. I'm like, there's no mistake. He then threatened me and said, fuck you. And he goes, oh, I don't know. He wouldn't do that. Okay. Fucking infuriating. That's why I'm no longer friends with the guy. Or working with him. I don't want anybody to go hate the guy or crap on him. But it's going to happen until you block people. You got to block these trolls so they don't trigger you. Because it's got nothing to do with me. Stop bringing me up.
like for donations, that doesn't make me any worse, okay?
Because I'm going to do a fucking show on it if you do.
Other people, okay, you know who other people beg for donations? I hate this.
This chick has to move out of the way because he starts getting into the camera, like in front of the camera. He starts like shoving her.
The mask is falling off.
And the mask is coming off.
COVID!
Having a fucking conniption over me. I'm not even there.
Hey, towards this, Joe Cronin begs for donations, but he slightly begs for donations. That's why he has his house, because of donations. That's why Joe Cronin has a house, because people like me and Foulmouthkin gave him that house. We made him money off that belt. You know that?
That was the goal of the belt. Yes, I created the belt to make extra money. That was the goal. That was the goal.
Joe Cronin money with that freaking belt. Okay, that's why Joe Cronin has a house. Years and years of people donating to him because of Brian Himmelfarb and other people.
Oh, God. Can you imagine? I don't know. Yes, thank you. Like, did I ever come out and say that that's... Did I ever come out and say, like, I did this all on my own, nobody helped me, and fuck everybody? Did I ever say that? No. Why is he bringing this up? Why is this coming up? I've never said anything like this. People in his chat are trolling him, saying, you're a beggar, Tommy. And then he's bringing me up. I never said anything about any of this. I've always liked everybody I've ever worked with, or I've always wanted to work with people and have fun. That's literally what I... That's why, hey, you called my show. I like you. I think you're entertaining. Want to be on my show with me? Like, cool. I like you. That's how it works with everybody. And eventually, people... Tommy's the only one where... I don't want to work with him anymore because of all this weird stuff going on. I'm actually the one saying we're done. All the other people that, or whatever, like, those are people that decide to leave the show. If you decide to leave the show, you know, you left the show. You wanted to leave the show, people want to leave the show, that's fine. But what is he acting like? And he leaves JB out and all kinds of other people out. I'm always thankful for everybody. I loved everything I did with anybody I do anything with in the past. But people decided to leave the show. Oh, well. And listen, Tommy's the first one where I'm cutting the ties myself. Because this dude is unhealthy and hates me in a weird, resenting way that I don't even understand. Maybe
hates
he's
himself, too.
Do you think he hates himself?
I don't doubt it.
I don't know.
No, I mean, I don't think so.
You don't think he hates himself? Like, cuts himself?
No. Oh, no, not that far. No, no.
Yeah, where was the Danny mod last night? He could have used Danny as a mod last night. He blocked me, but where was he to block these people? Most of these people
had... out of the woodworks if you were in there.
There were names like... Tommy's grandfather. All kinds of fucked up names that nobody was being banned. But anyway, I don't know. I don't know that much about who was in there because the video that I got didn't have the chat in it. So I don't know what was said to him elsewise because I got the video that somebody must have ripped, but I only saw some of it for a second, like the end of it live. So I was able to scroll through the chat to be like, what's going on in this? But I didn't see... Then it went private and I never saw anything. So I don't know who the... people are that were trolling him or whatever, but I don't know. The poor guy doesn't understand, and like, I don't know. People are fucking crazy. But JD does this too. JD gets trolled. He blames me, like, oh, it's that community. I'm like, this was your fan before. But Casey, live on the show, are you gonna burn?
Say one word.
No, are you gonna burn that? I'm gonna unmute him. Are you gonna burn that Jets jersey?
No, that's special to me. And plus, I think it'll be available.
What the fuck is special to you? What the fuck? What the fuck is special to you about a Brett Favre Jets jersey?
Hey, he only was a Jets for 1 year.
Oh my God. That's what's special?
Super Bowl champion, why not?
I want to...
Plus, there's a reason why... there's two reasons why.
Oh my God.
I have it. One, it was my late wife's.
Oh, okay.
And two is because when I came back to Oklahoma, my sister was a huge Green Bay fan. And
she
loved Brett Favre.
So you get her the
and Jets. I wore that just to piss her off one day.
Oh,
okay.
You would do that.
I feel like we missed the part where you were trying to say valuable.
You're lucky that you're
valuable.
Valuable.
There you go.
Oh, you got it. There you go.
you're lucky that you're,
yeah, there you go.
You're lucky you're deceived. You're lucky the deceased wife had something to do with it. Otherwise, I would have nailed you to the wall, and I would have had JB come over and bash your toes in with a hammer. But because it has some special thing with your deceased wife, then we'll leave it alone. But if not for her, I would string you up to a wall and hammer your toes like Jesus Christ into the wall.
I love how all the jerseys he wore tonight combined to one Super Bowl win. He throws one jersey on at the end. Let me finish, you tub of shit.
tub of butter.
But now you're wearing a jersey that combines five Super Bowls in one team. I'm glad that you finally got it right.
So, yeah, I remember Jets won a Super Bowl too.
I know. Of the three jerseys you wore prior to that Cowboys jersey, it added up to one Super Bowl win.
No.
Now you're wearing
Jets
something.
Jets won a Super Bowl.
Yes, I think one. One. Can you not count one?
Yeah, well, no. What? Dolphins also won a Super Bowl, too. They remember they had the perfect season.
Oh, okay. Whatever.
Season.
Okay, yeah. Right. So, well, yeah, we'll count that, I guess. Yeah, they had the perfect season. Yeah, they cheated.
What? Am I retarded, or did the Chargers win one?
Like 98%. Wow. Like 98%.
Did the Chargers win one?
Did the Chargers win one? What the hell is
I'm
wrong with you?
I'm not 100% sure.
I hope LaDainian Tomlinson takes his visor off and stares at your cock. All right?
Do you even watch football?
Fucking shoves it up your fucking...
Why do you have more jerseys than I have.
I haven't watched football in a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, like ever.
That's not true. I was a huge Cowboys fan.
Oh my God. What other teams are you fans? Why are you fans of all these fans? I mean, fucking teams.
At least you're somewhat close to Dallas, so you could...
Yeah, no, I'm actually a Cowboys fan. I just happen to have an old Dan Marino jersey that I had back in the 90s.
That's a real jersey. A fucking Dan Marino jersey is a real jersey. And even he couldn't win a fucking Super Bowl either, but what at least he has a fucking...
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Good
That's
Lord.
It. Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Joe, ever since I've been donating to I have gotten death threats on my phone on my old Twitter, people calling me a bastard for attacking a autistic, but you never hear me crying like Tommy because I have a set, so fuck your fans, Tommy Joe urethra man.
Jesus, that really happened to you, AJ Adams? That's how the hell does that happen? How do people even know who you are? How does it even happen? AJ Adams, thanks for the $3, though. That's weird. How the fuck how does that happen? By the way, we hit the goal. I hit the goal. Yes! Yes!
Here's the man that put you.
Please donate to me! Please donate! Come on, please! I need to fucking pay my car payment!
I'm getting hard, I got 9 inches inside of your wife. $9. I'm shooting my semen to the ceiling. I'm coming, and my balls have to move. Jacob Fuego.
JCS Army for life.
For life. Constipated life. Rock.
For life.
Yo, Constipated Rock. He is the king of the wheel. Constipated fucking rock. Jacob Fuego, you're a sexy beast tonight, man. I would fuck.
Fucking name, by the way.
Oh, yeah. I'd shove a cerveza up your ass. Nah, man, we'd smoke, dude. If I smoked with Jacob, dude, we would eat, like, I'd eat a bowl of macaroni.
Bro, I'm going to have you eating taquitos all
fucking night. Oh, taquitos.
Tamales sound good right now.
Ooh,
oh, dude.
Say that to tamales.
Quesadillas.
Tamale.
Quesadillas, man. Oh, please.
Quesadilla with some steak or chicken.
Yeah, steak and chicken quesadillas. I like to have both, believe it or not. And then... get some, like, fucking really hot sauce and Tabasco, and then some guacamole, and fucking boom, sour cream, put it all together.
Gotta be Tabasco.
I'll dip it in everything, dude. I'm fucking going, man. Quesadillas. I want fucking Mexican tomorrow. I'm having Mexican food.
Put it in my brown
food.
Ass, motherfucker.
Yeah, dude. I'll put it in. I'll fucking bend you over. Pull your pants down. I'll dip that fucking quesadilla in your fucking little grundle hole, and I'll fucking swipe it, and then I'll eat it like I like
grundle.
It. I'll be the bitch.
Grundle.
You are one nasty gringo, you heard?
Gurgle. yeah, fucking yeah, yeah. Oh, my gurgle.
Dude, I will fucking suck
you off. Z the Gamer, check your messages on Patreon. Yo, shout out to everybody who listened to my Morning Madness on Patreon this morning. If you didn't hear it, go listen to it. Z the... Boom. Let me see here. Let me check it out. Oh, I saw this. The Nazi couple.
The goon is on me tonight.
The goon. Yeah, he's not... He's like, this is bullshit. I've heard this guy. I get it. Jacob said we've had a little beef before, but you know what I mean? It's not been that bad, to be honest.
Have we really?
It's just it was just a couple things. You were being silly is all it was, I think. You've been cool for a long time and you've been a huge supporter too. And even when you're not a supporter, you're still you're still
and
here.
I'm gonna continue being a fucking supporter, even if I fucking disagree with you.
But
bro, people can't always
disagree with you.
And I don't think you like that too. I don't think you like that people always just disagree agree with you.
That's the worst.
I think
dude.
You do like when people disagree with you.
Well, it's bad. It sucks.
I've seen that before from you.
It sucks when if someone just keeps agreeing with me, but then somewhere else, somebody where I don't even know about is bashing me for something crazy. And it's what the fuck? Can I get something in the middle where somebody goes, well, what about Joe? You think maybe you do this because of this? And then I can actually answer it. And then we can maybe come up with an argument or something. I'd rather argue about it on my shit. But yeah, white couple wears Nazi masks. So it turns out this was they're not even racist and they're not Nazis. They claim that this is some kind of statement or something that they were trying to make about something. And I don't know anything beyond that. Drew, do you know about this?
I don't know the story itself, just that people were getting on them about wearing the mask. And it's a Nazi symbol. What do you want from us?
They can't have
Confederate flags anymore. So,
we died. White people died to stop Germany. And to stop this stuff. So now these people are just crazy looking for attention, I think. We died here in America fighting Germans to kill this stuff. So why are people in our country joking around wearing masks like that?
Well, that's what my point is. Bored. Is if it's considered racist or you're a piece of shit for having a Confederate flag, then what makes you think on God's green earth that it's okay to have a swastika on your fucking face?
It'd be funny if these guys were Democrats. Look up their voting history, find out if they're Democrats. I'm serious. Wouldn't it be hilarious if they find out those are Democrats? Probably are. I'm not saying that Democrats are all bad or something like that. I don't give a shit. I'm not a Democrat, not a Republican, but technically I am a Democrat because I've voted Democrat my whole life. But bottom line is, a lot of these people, it always turns out that they're fucking Democrats, and mentally ill or something.
Hey, I'm a Democrat. What the fuck?
Ugh.
Yeah, well, that explains you. No, I'm just kidding.
You're just a rat.
why do you have to align with any one party, Casey? Can you not think for yourself?
They were wearing the mask
to be ironic, someone says.
I'll be voting for Trump when it comes up this year.
Wait, you're a Democrat, but you're going to be voting for Trump?
I don't think Trump did a bad job. I think he did the best he could what happened during this year. You know, this year is not his fault.
No. I will say that
he wasn't just president for this year, though.
I'm not blaming him. I think he did okay the other years. I'm actually worried about what he did this year. That's me. I'm not blaming him for the pandemic because it's not his fault that this happened. He was killing it before this. But... Mm-hmm. But the way he has handled this, I don't like at all.
Everyone has handled this, Joe. Everyone.
I agree. Everyone has sucked.
I would agree with that. Humanity, bro.
Everyone has handled this like shit.
It takes 510 people to make something work, not one.
Wow. Who do you think? I think Biden drops dead right before the election.
And to be honest with you, those 510 people have to present shit to him.
Uh-huh.
For him to pass it. So where were they? Oh, they were too busy fighting each other and trying to kick him out.
Casey, Hillary or Biden? Who would you go for over each other?
Oh my God.
Hillary or Biden? You had to choose.
Better choose right.
You're gonna hate this. You know who I voted for last election?
You voted for Hillary last election, and now you're gonna vote for Trump?
Yeah.
Well, he likes murderous women.
You're hilarious.
Murderous women.
You might
you,
be.
You like people who eat babies?
Well, I was on the fence at the time. I was like, well, Who's the worst of the less
I mean,
of worst?
He likes kids. So.
Less who's the less of the two evil? Then you voted, but now you're going to vote for Trump 4 years later?
Yeah.
You might be the dumbest fuck I've ever met. No, I'm just
give me Trump forever.
I'm kidding, Casey.
Or you give me, oh, yo, give me, give me Trump
bubbly.
Forever as president.
Wow, really?
Before Hillary. Oh, I go, oh, Hillary. Before Hillary.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
I take Obama,
Jacob,
too.
Does it offend you that a Mexican guy cuts my grass and his makes me tamales, but one day she offered to suck my black soul pole and swallow my kids? Jacob is the man.
Oh.
Thank you, baby. I'm Colombian. I'm not Mexican.
So. He's a black hater.
Same thing.
Right. Yeah, that's
fuck you.
That's, hey,
oh, we're all brown, right?
That's right, our right? Most our blackest and most racist to Hispanics listener, AJ Adams.
Sorry, Jacob.
Stop, AJ.
I think thank you, AJ Adams. Thanks, Constipated Rock, and thanks Soundwave 92. He dropped $40 earlier. I think that we have just about nailed everything, and we should get the fuck out of here, man. Anything anybody wants to say before we go?
Tommy's a bitch.
Tommy's a bitch.
You got to show Jacob some respect. There was a lot more walls for him to jump to get to America.
Wow.
A lot more. Especially for my fucking parents.
Please, guys, sign up for my Patreon. I do 30 hours of content on Patreon. Drew's mother comes on Patreon and shits on all of us on Corrupted from Saturday night. Please join my Patreon. Please, it's $1. And you get a bunch of other stuff if you become a $25 producer or a $10 VIP or a $5 Cronin Club member. Please join my Patreon. 330, that's not enough. We need fucking 500, please. Oh my God, my house. I'm going to lose my house and my kids are dying.
I'm Jacob Fuego and I cut his grass.
And Jacob Fuego cuts my grass because he's a yes man. Nice, my. Pour me a mojito. Good night, everybody. Thanks for listening to Throwdown. Subscribe, hit the like button, comment, all that bullshit, and check out the Patreon. I dropped some juicy morning madness this morning. Corrupted, more to come throughout the week. Plus, me and Jesse are going to be recording another After Dark.
Can't wait.
Jacob Fuego.
I just rejoined the Patreon too, bro. I can't fucking wait. I have to listen to everything I fucking missed.
I want to rejoin.
Oh, yeah. Casey's going through a tough time. I'll get you stuff if you want to hear.
I can do a couple bucks.
Well, I'll just send it back to you. But yeah, if you want to do it, it's easier. I love you. I love you all. Good night. Thank you guys. I hope you hit the like button. Can we get at least 100 likes tonight? At least 100. Hit that likey button. Under 100 makes me feel like I have something missing inside of my testicles. I got OCD, man. I got OCD. I love you all, guys. I appreciate everything everybody here in the chat has ever done and you guys do for me and all the co-hosts and everybody that's ever been a part of my show. I don't know what the fuck Tommy was talking about last night, but that was bullshit to me. And Drew, Jacob, man, love you both.
Awesome, dude. Oh, this was hilarious.
I had fun, man. This is
Tommy. Hey, Tommy, fuck you.
Oh. Jacob is angry at Tommy. I don't want people to be angry at the guy. I just wanted to respond to what, you know, was said the other day. Good night, guys. Thank you.
Yes, man.
Mwah. 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 I'm really going. I'm going to hang up on the Discord. I'm going to hang up on the Discord, too. Like, I want you to.
I agree with that, Joe. Good call.
With hanging up on the Discord?
Yeah. Well, I'm just
yesing. Oh, you're a yes man. Okay.
Yeah. I always agree with you at everything.
You better, or you're fine.
I agree with Drew.
I don't like that. Yeah, I do like fighting with people. I used to fight with Dave Rose all the time on the show back in the day. I never fought. I never said you're fired. Me and him would fight, and it'd be hilarious.
I try to find things to disagree with, and we do occasionally, but I'm sorry I agree with the shit you say.
Well,
I mean, you threw up two people with swastikas on their fucking face. What do you want me to say?
Yeah, you know I liked them. I don't know. It's not fun to fight with you at all anyway. So when we don't agree, I just go, oh, whatever, Drew's retarded.
I'd say COVID-19, we probably disagreed more than most topics.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. But I think it's good to be different because it really balances things out. So whatever. Mm. But yeah, man, like there was only one time where I got in a fight with Dave where I hung up on him. And that was not that long ago. And I regret that because I wasn't, I shouldn't have done that. I should have allowed him back on. But
Not the recent time that it happened. That was, he deserved to be hung up on that time. But the first time earlier in the year. But we had a lot of fights before that, and I love fighting. I love getting in an argument. Let's do it. You know, and eventually we calm down and have fun, you know. But like, yeah, dude, a little argument? Fuck yeah, let's go. Disagree with me all day. I welcome it. Somebody fucking email me that you want to be on my show because you're funny. I'll put you on my show. Somebody email me that you want to yell at me about stuff because you disagree, and I'll put you on the show. I won't ban you.
I mean, look.
I'll put you on the show.
Casey's here. He'll put anyone on.
Right, and he's infuriating. He's got a fucking Jets jersey with a fucking Favre on the back of it. God damn it, motherfucker. Good night, everybody.
Cheers.
Ridiculous piece of shit.
Shout out to the $25 producer patrons. Thank you guys for making the show even more special.
Dildo acid.
And they're going out for some hanging.